has fallen to the U.S.-backed Free Syrian Army rebel faction, whose Southern Front group has been fighting out of the neighboring Jordan. Issam al-Rayes, the spokesman for the Free Syrian Army, claimed that the base was taken after a six-hour battle and that 67 Syrian soldiers were slain in the fighting. 11 Free Syrian Army fighters were also reported killed in the raid, which routed the Brigade 52 site. This is the latest in a series of major losses by the Syrian military nationwide, with recent losses in Idlib province to Al-Qaeda forces and losses in Palmyra to the Islamic State. With losses across the nation, Syria's government has less and less territory remaining. The base marks a rare victory for the U.S.-backed rebels in Syria, who control only a handful of villages around Daraa, depending on the Jordanian support for control over the border region. Al-Qaeda also has a significant presence in the area, but thus far has avoided direct fighting with them.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports a federal appeals court on Tuesday upheld a strict anti-abortion law in Texas that will close all but seven abortion providers in the state. A three-judge panel in the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals in New Orleans ruled to uphold the 2013 Texas law, which requires that abortion clinics meet the standards of outpatient surgical centers. Under the law, abortion facilities must include minimum sizes for rooms and doorways and meet other structural and ventilation system requirements. Doctors must also have admitting privileges at local hospitals. In response to a lawsuit brought by three abortion clinics, a federal judge in Austin, Texas, ruled in August that the surgical center regulation is unconstitutional because it would restrict too many women's access to abortion. Amy Hagstrom-Miller, head of Whole Woman's Health in McAllen, Texas, an abortion provider and plaintiff in the case, said many women opt for methods that can be used at home if they don't have easy access to a clinic. Supporters of the surgical center requirement argue it protects women's health. The Fifth Circuit Court ruled in favor of the Texas law, except where it applies to Whole Women's Health, which is located in the Rio Grande Valley, about 200 miles from the nearest legal abortion center under the law. The Center for Reproductive Rights, which represented the plaintiffs in the lawsuit, said it intends to appeal the ruling. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. To date, Coinbase has more than 1 million consumer wallets and is trusted by over 25,000 merchants, including Overstock.com, Khan Academy, Reddit, and of course, FPP. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Arkansas must recognize as lawful some 500 same-sex marriages that were performed during a six-day window in May 2014. The marriages have been in legal limbo since the Arkansas Supreme Court halted same-sex marriages less than a week after they began in order to hear the state's appeal. A lower court had ruled that the state's ban on same-sex marriage violated the Equal Protection Clause of the Arkansas and U.S. constitutions. The state subsequently refused to accept joint tax returns for same-sex couples who had wed and declined to enroll spouses of gay and lesbian government employees in the state health insurance programs. The Arkansas Supreme Court has yet to decide the matter. Some of its justices have complained that their colleagues are avoiding the issue in hopes that the U.S. Supreme Court will relieve them of any political fallout with its expected ruling on the issue later this month. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Today's most popular video games take place in dangerous post-apocalyptic landscapes. But are these games enough to prepare our kids for the actual post-apocalyptic future we will all soon face?
Well, I think these games are quite effective at teaching our kids skills like finding shotgun ammo and leading elite squads of super soldiers.
But these aren't the advanced skills that they're going to need. They're going to need the more practical skills like how to find drinking water by collecting the morning dew in human skulls.
Or how to deal with depression when the sun is blocked out. out for 500 years by a cloud of radioactive dust.
Absolutely. Now, that's the type of knowledge these kids are going to need when their world has been turned into a brutal hellscape.
But these kids said that they know how to find items to barter at weapon shops and how to use medicine packs to heal zombie bites.
The games make it all seem deceptively simple. I mean, in the future, a kid's not going to be able to kill a six-foot-long irradiated beetle just by pressing a few buttons, and he's going to have to get down there with an axe and hack and hack and hack.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program. You can join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, you have me, Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
And Dave Ridley is here, courtesy of RidleyReport.com. We'll talk more about that coming up here in a little bit. Dave is currently preparing another Croatian atrocity to share with us from the 1990s in response to what has been happening in Liberland, which I think we were talking about Liberland. Was it last week? I know you were here,
yeah,
so maybe
yes.
It was last week or 2 weeks ago. But, of course, Dave, you are familiar more so than others with the Bosnian Serbian conflict in the 1990s.
The Serbo-Croat conflict.
Serbo-Croat.
Well, both, I guess, yeah.
Well, Bosnia was involved in some way. I honestly don't know that much about it. I was just
a teenager. Well, many Serbs and Croats would claim that parts of Bosnia should be parts of Bosnia, or should be parts of Serbia and Croatia. I don't buy
and
that
or,
idea.
Okay, but, gotcha. Yeah. So we've been talking about Liberland over the last several weeks, if not few months here on Free Talk Live. This is the 3-square-mile plot of land that actually exists between Serbia and Croatia, correct?
Yes.
And it is in the Danube River, and it's basically no man's land, essentially, or no country's land. These countries that are bordering it have never claimed it as their own, and so these guys who are purportedly liberty-minded, people that we might really get along well with, have gone to this place and have attempted to claim it as another country, as a new sovereign nation called Liberland. And so that's what we've been following here on Free Talk Live. And of course, we'll talk to you about anything you want, so you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. But over the last few weeks, there have been some arrests of individuals who have intended to go to Liberland, to that plot of land. They have attempted to go from Croatia and have been arrested essentially for a border crossing violation, meaning that the Croatian government has set up certain locations that it deems to be the appropriate place to cross the border into neighboring Serbia. However,
the United States has some of the same problems. I guess you could probably get in trouble for trying to leave the United States without government permission, too. And it's just such a basic fascistic thing. You know, I mean, the ability to leave is such a basic human right.
Freedom, sure.
People are always telling you and me to do it, right?
So, if you don't like it, leave.
Well, we're almost not allowed to without government permission. And I guess it's more official in Croatia that they're actually admitting you've got to be at a checkpoint to leave their lovely country. Why would anyone want to leave?
Exactly. So here's the news from Osijek, Croatia.
Well, I don't know about getting told to leave. I've been told to leave many times. You don't like your freedom. Get out. That kind of thing. But I think what we're seeing here is that when you actually do try to go someplace where you potentially believe you can have more freedom or build a society with more freedom or something like that, then you will not be able to do that, that they'll try their best to prevent you from doing it. What they mean is if you don't like our bullies here, go someplace where the bullies are worse. You should be lucky you get bullied the way you get bullied here. You don't even know what bullying's like.
Except you're not allowed to leave.
Take a smack.
Without the authority's permission, yeah. So why would anyone want to leave a pretty place like Croatia unless they had a fascistic government?
So how did you pronounce this place?
Osijek.
Osijek, Croatia. On Sunday, June 7th, armed agents of the Croatian government abducted two Liberland citizens, both protected persons under the Geneva Conventions, from the occupied territory of Liberland and forcibly transferred them to Croatia, where they were imprisoned under appalling conditions. One of these protected persons was a minor, just 17 years of age. The boy's basic humanitarian rights to water, food, and daylight were denied by Croatian authorities despite repeated pleas, in direct contravention of Article 76 and 118 of the Fourth Geneva Convention. This, by the way, coming from the Liberland Settlement Association's press
release. It wouldn't be a bad idea for us maybe to look at what the independent or what the press is saying about this. That's not Liberland Press, right?
Yeah, I don't know if any other press is covering this, so you're welcome to Google around and see if you can find it.
Fourth Geneva Convention. It's not like they're listening to anything that was written down in the first three.
Yeah. He was released from forced imprisonment the following day with no charges pressed. The second Liberland citizen remains in prison. The Liberland Settlement Association demands the immediate release of this citizen and calls again for the cessation of grave violations of the Geneva Conventions on the part of Croatia, the occupying power. This latest provocation was a coordinated attack by 9 Croatian police boats, 12 off-road police vehicles, 2 police vans, and some 75 armed agents against 2 unarmed, peaceful residents of Liberland who had committed no crime nor displayed any aggression towards the occupying forces.
And where were they when this arrest occurred?
Well, they're exactly. talking of, it sounds like they were actually in Liberland.
It that says, would be significant because mostly there haven't been people in Liberland.
Yeah, because the opening paragraph said they abducted 2 Liberland citizens from the occupied territory of Liberland and forcibly transferred them to Croatia.
Again, where's the video? Why aren't these people showing us more video?
I agree. I would love to see the video of this supposed, 75 agents for 2 people here. These actions, I'm not saying I doubt the claims, but video would make it that much more persuasive, that much more shareable. These actions, together with previous offenses over the last several weeks, constitute a systematic practice by Croatian forces against the civilian population of Liberland. These attacks can no longer be described as isolated or sporadic events, but are clear manifestations of directed Croatian government policy towards the inhabitants of Liberland.
You know, it may be that there is a little bit of a holdover from, again, the mentality towards little breakaway republics. If you're Croatian government, when you think about that, it brings bad memories because when the Serbian minority tried to make their own republic inside Croatia, that was very ugly, and many Croats unnecessarily suffered and were temporarily ethnically cleansed from the area. There was this thing, I don't even remember what it was called, but I think it was Milan Babic, I guess, was running this this crazily overhyped republic that was, basically some checkpoints and some barricades, and
Serbians trying to create their own society in Croatia.
Right. Yeah. And then there was the Bihać pocket. There was all these little things, all these different places that have broken away from places and other places, and in the chaos. And so there is this sort of phobia probably in Croatia about the idea of anything seceding from Croatia, although that's not what Liberland is trying to do.
Every state has a phobia of something seceding. There's no doubt about it. But, I mean, we're talking about a piece of land that is neither claimed by Croatia, nor does it have any people on it that would at least be considered Croatian, right?
Like, that's
people,
right.
People are traveling to this piece of land through Croatia or Serbia because that's how you have to get there. I would hesitate to take a helicopter in. You'd probably get shot down. Mm. I don't think they have any, I get you're not making an excuse, but they have no excuse on this one. This isn't bringing back any bad memories of ethnic cleansing of Croats. There are
all
no Croats
yeah,
there.
All Croats would be welcome in that location. Right. It's the exact opposite of what the Serbian minority tried to do in the Krajina. But the other thing to keep in mind, and again, this is no excuse at all, but there's this mentality when they look back at their history and they think, okay, there was this time in history where Croatia was X number of square miles. It was huge. It included this. It included that. Every country in the Balkans does this. They look back to their great moment.
The glory
days.
And
they want to have that back. And so any loss of any territory is unacceptable. And that, again, that's what a lot of the fighting was over in the 90s.
Well, by using force and violence to escalate this conflict, Croatia, the occupying power, has violated Article 49 of the Geneva Convention the Fourth Geneva Convention, prohibiting transfer of protected civilians to the territory of the occupying power, of Article 76 and 118, prohibiting inhumane treatment of prisoners, and 71 and 72, providing for competent courts, and of Article 7 of the Rome Statute, prohibiting systematic imprisonment of a civilian population. Because the government of Liberland has publicly accepted and pledged to apply the Geneva Conventions, Croatia is obligated to respect the rights of Liberland citizens under those international agreements. While the Croatian Ministry of Foreign and European Affairs has called Liberland a joke Protecting the human rights of individuals is no laughing matter. To this end, the Liberland Settlement Association demands an immediate visit by the Croatian Red Cross in accordance with Article 76 of the Fourth Geneva Convention to ensure humanitarian treatment of the remaining Liberland citizen still confined in prison in Osijek?
Osijek.
Osijek.
I would love to know what is a joke about Liberland compared to any of the other little tiny countries around there. Explain to me the difference.
855-450-FREE. Maybe you can explain it. It's Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Honey, it's time for dinner. What are you doing over there on your computer?
I'm shopping for a new wallet. Mine is falling apart. Hey, did you know there's a company called ID Stronghold that makes shielded wallets to prevent electronic pickpocketing?
Oh, I didn't realize there was such a thing as electronic pickpocketing. What is that?
Well, apparently, many of the new credit and debit cards being issued have radio chips inside them called RFID that transmit our banking information to card readers when we pay. Unfortunately, a bad guy can also get one of these readers and go around the city scanning people, collecting their credit card numbers and personal information without us knowing it.
Wow, that sounds scary. Since you're getting a new wallet anyway, you should definitely get an ID Stronghold shielded wallet. Are they more expensive?
No. In fact, I can get a shielded leather wallet from IDStronghold.com for the same price or less than regular unshielded wallets from other stores.
Sounds great. My wallet isn't falling apart yet, but let me pick one out too. I want to be protected, and these wallets at IDStronghold.com look fantastic.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online as well at freetalklive.com. Lots of features await you there, so go and enjoy and get interactive for free at freetalklive.com. Spend Bitcoins is for sale. You probably know about Spend Bitcoins if you've been around the Bitcoin universe for a little while. SpendBitcoins.com, one of the most popular websites out there because it's the number one Google search for terms like, where can I spend Bitcoins? They've got over 10,000 Bitcoin-accepting merchants listed on the site, and the entire directory is for sale. We're not just talking about the URL. The site itself is for sale. It's where you can sell Bitcoin, sell ads, sell premium listings. The world is your oyster when you own Spend Bitcoins. So go to spendbitcoins.com/sale. That's spendbitcoins.com/sale. This is one of the oldest and largest Bitcoin merchant directories out there. spendbitcoins.com/sale. So we've been talking about the latest attack on the innocent people, the peaceful people of Liberland, the 3-square-mile area between Croatia and Serbia, where people are trying to settle. Some liberty-minded folks from around the world, mostly Europe, are trying to settle in there. And they've had better, I guess they've had a little better luck coming in from the Serbian side. But in this case, apparently the land is now occupied, they're claiming. This is the Liberland Settlement Association and their press release that we finished reading a few moments ago, where they are saying that a couple of their friends were kidnapped from Liberland. So what had been happening, and I don't know, they don't tell us when this was going on, but we know that there have been these Liberland parties that have been happening over the last few weeks. If you go to the Liberland Facebook page, you'll see some of the events that they've been making, and they've had 3 or 4 different weekend-long camping excursions, basically. And we had some question about whether or not they were going into Liberland, but it only makes sense that they would be. They were gathering at a gathering site in Serbia and then presumably going into Liberland from there. So it was this past Sunday when these two gentlemen were arrested by Croatian government gang members, and they claim there were quite a few of them. They claim 75 armed agents, 9 Croatian police boats, 12 off-road police vehicles, and 2 police vans came out to kidnap these two men. One of them, the 17-year-old, was released. Another, who is not named in this particular press release, is allegedly still in prison in Croatia, and I don't know what he's being charged with. The article doesn't give us that level of detail, but it doesn't sound like things are going well out in Liberland, and I wish them the best. I hope they can see this through.
Well,
it sounds like they're
I disagree.
These guys are dedicated.
No, it's going well as long as they're getting publicity. Having arrests,
but are they getting publicity?
Having arrests isn't going to hurt Liberland much. They seem to be getting, over the long haul, they're getting a lot of international publicity. But did this particular arrest get ignored?
Well, I don't know. Let's see. I'm just looking for Liberland arrests.
Meanwhile, I have my Croatian war crime ready for delivery.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not seeing anything popping up fresh in the Google News search, at the very least, for Liberland arrests.
Aren't you a little dubious about the 75 Croat army invasion of Liberland here? I mean, I don't know what else to call this except an invasion.
Yeah, they're calling it occupied territory in this article.
What's the track record on this site? You know, I mean, how accurate have they been in the past? Have they let us down before?
Well, we don't know how accurate they are. We have to take their word for it, right? I mean,
following them a little bit for the last couple of weeks, haven't you?
I mean, we've generally followed the news from Liberland. Some of that news has come from the Liberland Settlement Association. This is a group of people who are dedicated to encouraging people to move to Liberland.
Well, maybe I should keep my Croatian war crime on hold until we have verification
of
this.
That's the thing.
Abuse.
How do you get verification
right.
of this?
Right. Well, video. But yeah, mainstream press reports would also be helpful.
I'm not seeing anything like that, but that doesn't mean it didn't happen. I mean, frequently there are stories here in Keene, New Hampshire that we break news of over at freekeene.com, and nobody else ever picks it up. So how do you verify that?
Yeah.
You were either there, and we do get video. So, like, you know, we've got that part down here pretty good and keen. And that would certainly help this situation
it's
here.
So funny. I mean, I'm always saying how helpless average Americans seem to be against their government.
Apparently, it's people and
yet,
around the world.
And it appears that even the Liberlanders don't know these basics. Yeah, get the video. Get the video.
I'm going to go ahead and say that I think something happened. This I want to see corroboration of some sort, some kind of proof that this... I mean, an invasion of Liberland occurred by Croat forces. Like, I'd like to see a little more of that, but I'm going to go ahead and say clearly something happened.
I was just Googling it to try and find what the Liberlanders had shot themselves. I was searching YouTube. I couldn't find anything recent. There was a Dnevnik report from Croatia, a mainstream Croatian outlet. It was a TV report, it looked like, and the reporter was apparently inside the – she was inside the – Liberland itself, but this seems like so few people have actually gotten inside there.
Yeah, I can't say for sure. I mean, there are people that will say they're attending these parties on Facebook. Hundreds of people will say they're attending, but that doesn't mean anything. I mean, anybody who's ever put a Facebook event together knows that sometimes the attendee count is close to accurate, sometimes it's wildly inaccurate, and sometimes it's wildly inaccurate in a negative or positive manner. So you really can't predict anything just by looking at a Facebook event and say, oh, well, there were that many people there. Yeah. The only thing you can go by is when somebody takes a picture of the people who are attending, and I can tell you the pictures I've seen have not shown hundreds of people. It has shown maybe, you know, a dozen or something like that.
It's so interesting, just a historical note, that Osijek, where they're holding these prisoners, or where they were holding them, that was actually the front line in the Serbo-Croat War, and it was shelled very heavily. I think the Croats held it and still hold it.
So here's an interesting detail for you, Dave. I just went to the Liberland Facebook page, which kind of has a lot of updates from the Liberland, you know, I guess the official government or whatever there. And there's no mention of the arrest there. So, I mean, maybe they don't want to promote, maybe the government of Liberland does not want to promote the fact that people are being arrested there. Maybe they're not yet aware of it, but I would presume they are based on the way the press release was worded here.
Yeah, so if they don't want to promote arrests, they're going to lose.
Now, Mark, you apparently are in the Liberland Settlement Association group on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, I liked it.
I am not a part of – no, that's you are in a group, not something you like. That would be something that you join.
Okay, fine.
And that would be where there would be maybe some discussions going on perhaps.
Haven't spent much time in there, honestly.
I would like to suggest that you go to that group and see if there's anything – because we're trying to determine what's happening here. And you're the one person in the studio who's already a part of it. Maybe there's more information. Maybe that's where we might find video. I mean, maybe there is video, but the Liberland Settlement Association just isn't with it enough to know to put it online or something like that. Maybe somebody's just dropped it on their Facebook page and they figure that's good enough. I mean, just because these guys are organizing a country, Dave, doesn't mean they're media experts, right?
Thomas has been released. Thomas was arrested Sunday early afternoon together with Kristen 100 meters inside Liberland after exiting Liberland, having spent 100 meters inside Liberland after exiting Liberland. Let's call that outside.
Strange.
Having spent a day and a night there. I'm going to guess this English isn't the primary language here of Nicholas, who's posting this. A lot of police was called on scene during the arrest. Serbian police was also called on site and involved in the process, but
really?
Serbian police called in, advised their Croatian colleagues to just let the boys go with no further charges. Obviously, the Croatians did not agree. Instead, of all their electronic equipment and mobile phones were seized, and they were put in police cars and driven off.
Okay, so maybe their video was confiscated.
Well, but we know that one was released. I wonder which one you're saying there was released.
It was just released. 5 hours
ago. Okay, more coming up.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
A new Gallup poll found that the GOP has an overwhelming advantage among young people who look like old men. The poll shows Republicans hold a solid lead among the coveted elderly youth demographic, including 18 to 24-year-olds who wear suspenders and bow ties to class every day. I'm joined by Republican strategist Rob Powell. These are pretty encouraging numbers for the GOP, aren't they?
Yeah, of course, it's very encouraging. Millennials who look like they're permanently dressed for boat trips are a rapidly growing segment of the population.
And according to the survey, the prematurely aged are also very politically active.
Absolutely. Only about 20% of young people vote overall, but there's almost 100% turnout among youth that dress like a dad from a 1950 sitcom.
Now, what about the criticism that the GOP only appeals to white men?
Not true. We also have a lot of support among sorority girls that wear pantsuits and pearls, paunchy Chinese college students, and we're making inroads among African-American ham radio enthusiasts.
This is the Onion News Network.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the latest from Liberland. Mark is in their Facebook group for the Liberland Settlement Association. Apparently, the one guy that had been kidnapped, there were two people kidnapped this weekend by the Croatian government goons. One was released relatively quickly after a night in jail, and then the other was just released literally hours ago. We've got more details on their story, what exactly transpired. We did read this, the press release from the Liberland Settlement Association. This is the story that's inside their Facebook group. We'll tell you more about that here in a moment. Of course, Liberland is the destination for a lot of people in the Europe area to come to have a shot at freedom, or at least that's the way it seems. That's the idea, at least the concept of it, is to carve out a 3-square-mile plot of land between Serbia and Croatia and create a free place, a place with very little government interference in people's lives. Everything sounds great as far as the concept of Liberland. It's just the whole making it happen thing is the difficult part. That's where you run into these governments who, of course, don't like change. They don't like the idea that there could be a new government in the world, and they certainly don't like people crossing their border at a place where they say you can't cross the border. So they've been arresting people for that.
But as always, it's the conflict that makes the people, right? I mean, Israel wouldn't exist if there weren't so many atrocities committed against Jewish folks. And in the same way, any atrocity committed against Liberland, which, you know, in a sense, an arrest is a small atrocity, that's going to, in theory, make them more powerful.
It could, but they're not getting much press coverage out of
this. Not on this last one. I mean, there's a lull. Now, they can live through a lull and still survive, but they're going to have to, over the long haul, keep the attention on.
Well, right. And think about it. I mean, had they actually come out with some kind of video of this, because the way it was described is not quite 100, but 75 armed agents that were supposedly swarming over Liberland and then arresting these guys.
That's an invasion.
That would have made for a very shareable, very possibly viral video, which could have really kind of kept them at the top. But
and
what you said
there's been some indication their electronics were confiscated, so maybe they couldn't get some of their video out. But again, that's where you create a chain, or you know, you have a videographer that is further away that records the process of the cameras being stolen, or you have a live stream or something like that.
So I don't know that this, so the story you're reading sort of doesn't corroborate the facts in this other story.
Interesting. I want to get to that story here in a moment, but you can call in about anything. Dennis is in North Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Dennis.
Hi there.
Hey, Dennis, go ahead.
Okay. I've seen a notice from the ACLU about a mobile phone cell phone app for recording police brutality.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's called Mobile Justice.
Cool.
It has a record function. It uploads it. I assume this is like streaming video, and it goes straight to the cloud somehow, and it so that if a phone gets confiscated or destroyed, the record is still there with the video that's been recorded. Hmm.
The way I saw it when I saw the video of it is you kind of have to push this button to send it, to send the video.
So it doesn't stream as it's recording?
Right. I'm going to have to say, from what I have seen, I do not think that this app is the best choice that we can make.
It sounds inferior to Bamboozer.
But they could improve on it. I mean, at least, I mean, think about it. The ACLU has an app for recording police. It's a start.
Awesome. It's a good start. Yeah, there's no doubt about it. Thanks for the heads up, Dennis. Anything else you want to share with us tonight?
Hey, I was just wondering if the Cop Block organization was working with ACLU.
I don't know. That's an excellent question. I mean, there's so many different police accountability organizations out there. Cop Block is certainly one of the biggest ones. It wouldn't surprise me if at some level they were, but I certainly haven't heard about any linkage like that. But thank you for the heads up tonight, Dennis.
Yeah, an umbrella organization would work well to bring everybody in, get everybody working together.
Thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you, Dennis. The only problem with bringing everybody together is that sometimes that creates more trouble than it's worth. Sometimes
everybody doesn't agree.
Yeah, not everybody agrees. So there's been a bit of a spat, from what I understand, between Cop Watch and Cop Block, and they used to get along, but now like some of the admins, if you will, the people who are in charge of these organizations. If you want to say that, I mean, Cop Block is a very decentralized group, but there's still somebody who's running the website, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the people who are in charge of Cop Block, the people who are primary in Cop Watch at the national level, have had a falling out, and so that's been a little ugly sort of behind the scenes. So it's nice when groups can link together and there's synergy there, but it also can be difficult sometimes. So I don't know. I feel like having diverse options out there is valuable. I think having different groups taking different approaches is important, because not everybody values the same approach. And the same thing's true of, you know, the ACLU. I don't think they would probably necessarily side with Cop Block on everything that Cop Block does. So,
well, and what was it that Sun Tzu said? The smaller the army, the more mobile and fast it is. You know, and if you start linking up with a bunch of people, what you're really doing is slowing yourself down. You got to focus on what you can do yourself.
So good advice there, Dave. Let's talk about, Mark, the story here. You're saying this is from one of the people who was there. Was it from a witness? Who was reporting this?
This is from Nicholas, who is in the Liberland Settlement Association.
So it's the same organization that sent out the press release that we read earlier, talking about all the Geneva Convention violations of these arrests.
Yep. So Nicholas isn't, from what I can tell, a native English speaker. He certainly doesn't have a last name like a native English speaker, I can tell you that.
Take a hack at it.
That's a Norwegian name, I think.
Yeah. Well, this is a private group, so I'm not going
to
share that last name.
That's a nice thing to do, Mark. Good point. This is a private group. Maybe you shouldn't be sharing this at all.
Well, I mean, it's breaking. It says bracking.
Okay. All right. If it's breaking, then that sounds like news.
They let me in.
Yeah, okay.
I don't know. Anyway.
It doesn't say keep this private or anything.
It doesn't say that.
Okay.
Bracking. Thomas has been released. Thomas's story. Thomas was arrested Sunday afternoon together with Kristen 100 meters inside Liberland after exiting Liberland.
Okay. Seems strange.
I don't know whether that means outside Liberland. That's the thing, is I don't get what they mean here.
The original press release said they were arrested inside Liberland, so that's another point that we can look at there.
Having spent a day and a night there. So the reason I'm going to read it, and I'm not going to I'm going to read this the way it's written, is that you can infer what you want to infer from this. I'm not trying to make fun of the guy's English or anything like
that. It is what it is. We'll infer some more here in a moment. But have you or someone you know ever been a victim of electronic pickpocketing? If not, you might be wondering what electronic pickpocketing is. Thankfully, it may not have happened to you yet. But it could, because a thief could pass near you with a scanner and then read your RFID chips that are in many of the debit and credit cards that are issued to folks nowadays, which means they could then compromise your identity, perhaps, and certainly use your credit card information to make purchases for themselves without your authorization. So you can now prevent electronic pickpocketing from happening to you thanks to ID Stronghold. They've been making products to block electronic pickpocketing since 2005. Some of their most loyal customers are military personnel that place a high value on personal security. And now you can have that same protection in the form of great leather RFID blocking wallets made by ID Stronghold. All you need to do is switch your wallet for a quality leather wallet from ID Stronghold with built-in protection against electronic pickpocketing. I've got one of these wallets, and I really like it thus far.
Yeah, it's been going good for you?
It has. Visit idstronghold.com to see their huge selection of his and hers wallets. That's idstronghold.com. You'll surely find one that's right for you. Tell them Ian Freeman sent you. Again, that's idstronghold.com. As we go to your calls and thoughts, you can join us via Skype. Pete is on the line with us. Pete, you're on Free Talk Live. Where are you calling from tonight?
Calling from Pennsylvania.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Hey, thanks. Hey, big fan, by the way. Love the show. I promote it all the time.
Thank you. You're on with Ian, Dave Ridley, and Mark.
Okay, great. So the last few weeks, it seems you guys have been pushing for that cops should not point guns at unarmed people.
It seems reasonable.
True?
Yeah, I guess.
Right. And what I'd like to say, though, is I think you guys should have the right, you personally should have the right to point guns at unarmed people. So,
well, I want to hear more about this.
Okay.
Yeah, I definitely want to hear more about that. Yeah. So stand by, Pete.
Having never pointed a gun at an unarmed person, it's interesting.
We'll bring you back. More with Pete and your calls and thoughts. Welcome. 855-453. We are in Point of Fact talking about disarming the police, talking about the different societies, countries of the world that police don't have guns when they're walking around on patrol. And everything's okay there. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Quantum Vibe. It's year 2523. There are colonies on Venus, Mars, and Mercury. People travel in bubbles, fly at hyperspeed, with brain implants and artificial gravity. A scientific genius and his clever assistant set out on an adventure through the solar system on a secret mission to find the key to access new frontiers and save liberty. QuantumVibe.com from Big Head Press.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free to join us here. We've got more coming up about Liberland and the most recent arrests that are happening there, that happened there over the weekend. In a series of arrests, probably half a dozen people, if not more, have been. Didn't they say like a dozen were arrested at one point? I'm losing track. There have been several arrests in Liberland. We'll talk more about it coming up with you in the studio tonight. It's Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
Join us over at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, then get your shopping taken care of and go to shop.freetalklive.com to do so. There are links to Amazon there. You click into the right Amazon for you, and Free Talk Live will get a cut of the purchase price. So whatever it is you need to buy at Amazon, Free Talk Live gets a slice when you go to shop.freetalklive.com. It's the same great prices, the same huge selection, the free Super Saver shipping, Amazon Prime. It's the same Amazon that you're used to. You're just going through our affiliate link, so Free Talk Live gets a portion of the sale. So once again, that's shop.freetalklive.com. We got Pete on the line in Pennsylvania. Now, Pete, you wanted to address pointing guns at, was it unarmed people?
Yes, and what I'm trying to get at is when people say unarmed, it does not necessarily mean not dangerous. Mm-hmm. And to sort of illustrate this, Mark, a question for you. So if you could imagine some of the worst people in prison and maybe they weren't put away for a violent offense, but they were tough dudes. And can you imagine, think of the toughest guy you know, and would you
I didn't meet him in prison, but okay.
Right. Okay. Maybe you didn't. Toughest guy you knew in prison. And would you want Ian to have the ability to shoot that person if Ian was threatened with his life?
Yeah, I can see what you're saying. I mean, like the old saying that God made man and Sam Colt made him equal.
Right. And you know, I don't know if Ian, you're a kung fu master or anything like that.
But, no, he's not. He's a skinny little wimp.
Okay, skinny wimp. I didn't want to say, you know, the W word, but what I'm getting at is now imagine you have more than one person. Maybe they're average size, but you have a disproportionate amount of force leveled against someone simply because they're outnumbered. Now, those people collectively may be unarmed, but they're not dangerous. And so you have situations in Baltimore. I read this on both CBS Baltimore and Breitbart, where the cops are pulling away from, let's say, urban areas of the city in order to, because when they show up to the scene of a crime, they're actually get surrounded and mobbed by 30, 50 people. And so they retreat.
Well,
and so crimes themselves are not actually being investigated.
So we have recommended here on Free Talk Live, you know, regardless of what you think about the racial situation in the United States, I think that we can be clear that some people believe that there is racism endemic in police departments around the United States.
And I buy that.
Yeah. Well, okay. I'm certainly believe that there are some racist cops, but I think that a lot of what we have is just sort of a misunderstanding between cultures. And what my opinion is if you can't draw from that community police officers of similar racial makeup of the community. So I'm saying that if the community is 50% black and 50% white, maybe you should have a department that's somewhere close to 50% black and 50% white. If you cannot find people who are from that community who are able to be police officers in that community, then that community doesn't deserve police protection, right? Like, they should have people coming from their community providing them with protection. That's what I'm saying. And at that point, you won't have circumstances. You will have far fewer circumstances where you've got cops getting surrounded by groups of hoods when they're in some neighborhood that they, you know, don't want to be from. They don't want them in there.
Right. But I can understand that might be the case in Ferguson, where I believe the police force was about 90% white and the population was 60% black. But in Baltimore, that's not necessarily the case. You know, the demographics of the police force actually reflect the demographics.
Yeah, I don't know if Baltimore is losing, if the police are losing ground.
The Freddie Gray cops, even in Freddie Gray, the cops were split 50-50 between white and black.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening in Baltimore as far as the cops losing ground or whatever. I mean, do they have a riot in Baltimore? They certainly do. But, the point I would make here is that police, there is a great deal of pressure extant in here in the United States against police departments for using force, specifically against black males, but using force on unarmed people. And police departments are becoming cognizant of that. And I think that's a good thing. No, I'm still going to say the police are supposed to be brave, just paladins of truth, and they should not unholster that weapon until it is time to use it. Yeah, I can see why you might give a little more latitude to the average person, but that latitude isn't given. It's actually just the opposite. The latitude's given to police officers for unholstering a weapon.
Well, for them, it's time to use it any damn time they feel like it, it seems like. They very rarely get in trouble for using their gun.
Yeah, and it depends on where you are. I mean, I think if a New Hampshire police officer drew down on me, there would be some consequences, but it would be not so big a deal if a Dallas officer did that to me.
Pete, any other thoughts you want to share tonight?
No, I do like your point about about that. The one last point, though, is in your call to say that cops are bad and that lumping in, we need to demilitarize the police. I worry that your own voices are getting lost among.
I don't know if anyone said
cops are
bad.
Hold on. Let him make his statement.
I'm worried your voices are getting lost among those from leftist authoritarians who are pushing things like consent decrees on, let's say, the Baltimore Police Department.
Yeah, I don't know if anyone said cops are bad.
What's a consent decree?
That consent decree is where the Baltimore Police Department agrees to certain exchange for not getting sued.
Okay. They agree to certain things for not getting sued.
Centralization of police and less
Yeah, we're starting to lose you a little bit there. I don't think anyone – thank you for the call, Pete. I don't think anybody has said cops are bad as like a general statement here on Free Talk Live. Some police are bad people, and others allow those bad people to get away with their crimes, which by proxy is sort of bad.
Well, in a sense, they are all bad. It is what you do that makes you good or bad. And if you accept – if your salary is all coming from taxation and you're enforcing some victimless crime laws now and then, you might be better than all the other cops in America, but that's still doing more harm than good.
But not all cops are enforcing victimless crime laws. I mean,
Are you sure there's
– We had Straight Razor call in. Now, we don't know if he's
never enforced
a
victimless crime law in the last –
Or two? I don't have him on the line to ask him when the last time it was, but he seems like a pretty principled guy who avoids enforcing those laws.
I'm also going to say
fired over it. He says
it
right?
is like, pretty cool. I mean,
don't know if what he's saying is true, Dave. Once again, it's one of those things where we got to take his word for it because he's calling
the
show
video
and telling us. Well,
you can't show video
of
that,
right? He doesn't want to record video of him letting somebody off of a crime.
Well, not that, but the video of them telling him that he's going to be fired and they're going to prosecute him and stuff like that.
Well, okay, so I would take a different tack than Dave here. I'm not going to go call every police officer bad, but I am going to say that they work for a monopoly, and that has inherent incentives. So when you give somebody the power that's inherent in a monopoly on violence, then you're going to find that it warps their motives over time.
And will attract bad people, too.
It will attract both the corrupt, and it will corrupt the uncorrupted.
Yes.
Now, that's not to say that every cop is corrupt or been corrupted. It's just saying that the pressures exist. I would go so far as to say that every human being in those circumstances would be corrupt. So therefore, every cop has been corrupt at some point, and some cops make a business of it.
That's true.
Most people consider accepting stolen property, knowingly accepting it, to be a crime, a non-victimless crime, and that's what essentially all cops do through taxation.
Yeah, I mean, I'll give it to you, Dave Ridley, that probably most cops, even the ones that might not enforce a victimless crime laws, may still be out doing speeding ticket enforcement. I mean, there may be certain ways that they can't get out of doing that, like if they've got quotas or something like that. But we know there are cops who do the very best they can to be as low impact as possible.
Maybe all we can ask of them.
And I don't want to call those people bad people. I think that good people can do bad things when they have the wrong, motivations, when they have the wrong incentives or whatever. I know that Chris Cantwell, for instance, has been meeting and talking to some of the Keene police in town and connecting with them on a human level. And I think that that helps you understand, when you actually can have a conversation with a police officer, that these are human beings and they are doing the wrong thing in a lot of cases to their fellow man.
Yeah. And you think
about calling them bad isn't necessarily going to bring them to that conclusion, I guess. I don't know. We'll come back with more here. You can share your thoughts. We've got a couple more hours to go. Plenty of time for you to get in here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Still to come here tonight. In fact, I mentioned Cantwell. And Dave Ridley, you've got some thoughts about Chris Cantwell you wanted to talk about here. We can do that. Plus, 5 ways the powerful trick you into hating protesters. Mark will give us that story. It's Free Talk Live.
The Atlas Society's Atlas Summit is just around the corner, June 18th through the 21st, right before Porkfest in Nashua, New Hampshire. Connect, grow, have fun with longtime objectivists and people just learning Ayn Rand's philosophy. There are discounts for students, locals, and one-day rates at atlassociety.org. The event is jam-packed with speakers. Come and be a part of the most important objectivist event of the year, the Atlas Summit, June 18th through the 21st, Nashua, New Hampshire, atlassociety.org. 20% off with coupon code FTL, atlassociety.org.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Yeah.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, June 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.20 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,191 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $233. Antiwar.com reports the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights has reported that a key Syrian army base in the Daraa province has fallen to the U.S.-backed Free Syrian Army rebel faction, whose Southern Front group has been fighting out of the neighboring Jordan. Issam al-Rayes, the spokesman for the Free Syrian Army, claimed that the base was taken after a six-hour battle and that 67 Syrian soldiers were slain in the fighting. 11 Free Syrian Army fighters were also reported killed in the raid, which routed the Brigade 52 site. This is the latest in a series of major losses by the Syrian military nationwide, with recent losses in Idlib province to Al-Qaeda forces and losses in Palmyra to the Islamic State. With losses across the nation, Syria's government has less and less territory remaining. The base marks a rare victory for the U.S.-backed rebels in Syria, who control only a handful of villages around Daraa, depending on the Jordanian support for control over the border region. Al-Qaeda also has a significant presence in the area, but thus far has avoided direct fighting with them. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a federal appeals court on Tuesday upheld a strict anti-abortion law in Texas that will close all but seven abortion providers in the state. A three-judge panel in the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals in New Orleans ruled to uphold the 2013 Texas law, which requires that abortion clinics meet the standards of outpatient surgical centers. Under the law, abortion facilities must include minimum sizes for rooms and doorways and meet other structural and ventilation system requirements. Doctors must also have admitting privileges at local hospitals. In response to a lawsuit brought by three abortion clinics, a federal judge in Austin, Texas, ruled in August that the surgical center regulation is unconstitutional because it would restrict too many women's access to abortion. Amy Hagstrom-Miller, head of Whole Woman's Health in McAllen, Texas, an abortion provider and plaintiff in the case, said many women opt for methods that can be used at home if they don't have easy access to a clinic. Supporters of the surgical center requirement argue it protects women's health. The Fifth Circuit Court ruled in favor of the Texas law, except where it applies to Whole Women's Health, which is located in the Rio Grande Valley, about 200 miles from the nearest legal abortion center under the law. The Center for Reproductive Rights, which represented the plaintiffs in the lawsuit, said it intends to appeal the ruling. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. To date, Coinbase has more than 1 million consumer wallets and is trusted by over 25,000 merchants, including Overstock.com, Khan Academy, Reddit, and of course, FPP. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Arkansas must recognize as lawful some 500 same-sex marriages that were performed during a six-day window in May 2014. The marriages have been in legal limbo since the Arkansas Supreme Court halted same-sex marriages less than a week after they began in order to hear the state's appeal. A lower court had ruled that the state's ban on same-sex marriage violated the Equal Protection Clause of the Arkansas and U.S. Constitutions. The state subsequently refused to accept joint tax returns for same-sex couples who had wed and declined to enroll spouses of gay and lesbian government employees in the state health insurance programs. The Arkansas Supreme Court has yet to decide the matter. Some of its justices have complained that their colleagues are avoiding the issue in hopes that the U.S. Supreme Court will relieve them of any political fallout with its expected ruling on the issue later this month. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
According to a study released Thursday by the Princeton University Department of Biology, this local two-year-old woodland chipmunk has crafted a far more secure and dependable plan for the future than 8 out of 10 Americans. Reporters spoke to citizens to get their view on the study.
Clearly, this chipmunk is pretty impressive. I mean, he wakes up every morning and says, I need to collect acorns and berries for the winter. He sets goals for himself and he gets it done.
He has to make a burrow in a tree stump. That's exactly what he does. He doesn't pause and have a snack and lay around for a few hours.
Out of nearly 40 separate interviews with Americans, 33 told reporters they were very impressed by the chipmunk's continued display of foresight, personal responsibility, and pragmatic decision-making when considering his own future.
He's preparing for winter, he's building a home, and he's trying to get enough nutrients to make it throughout the rest of the day. All this while being worried about maybe getting eaten by a wolf or an owl or something. Earlier this week, the electricity went off in my home because I forgot to pay my bill. It's the second time this year.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you may join us here on the radio waves. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. You can join us online as well at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that we have waiting for you there. The we includes me, Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
And you can join us here also via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. For those of you just tuning in, there have been more arrests in Liberland as of Sunday. We've got more details on those coming up, plus the five ways the powerful trick you into hating protesters. Mark, you'll be sharing that with us here when we get a chance, but to your phone calls and thoughts first, in fact, to Skype first, where we have Miles on the line in California. Hello, Miles.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Welcome.
I just wanted to call in and wonder if you guys are paying attention to what's going on Reddit right now. Reddit.com.
Reddit's a big place. Site.
So. There's a big thing going on right now, though.
No idea.
Okay. So earlier today, their CEO slash moderator, there's a couple of them that are kind of what we call social justice warriors.
Okay.
And have been getting more and more onto the movement of censoring what goes on Reddit and what is allowed to.
That is not going to go well on Reddit.
Okay, well, it's already not going well right now. What happened is earlier today, they made their first big move into the realm of censorship by banning a handful of fairly popular controversial subreddits. The main being, I know it's kind of funny, but it's called the subreddit Fat People Hate. And it's a subreddit. I've never been there. I don't even really know what it's about, but apparently it's just kind of making fun of fat people, okay. which is mean. No, I don't think anyone here would.
There's no shortage of mean on the internet, that's for sure. And I imagine there's no shortage of mean in Reddit. But I want you to tell me more about what they banned. But is this really the first time? I feel like I've heard of other situations where.
Well,
Reddit has...
No. Stories have been banned before.
Stories.
And posts have been removed, that's a big deal, yeah. And there have been subreddits that were shut down before, but much more easily defendable, like really, really bad stuff.
Hitler did nothing wrong. Reddit subreddit or something like that.
No. Worse than that.
Like child pornography.
Like child porn. Yeah. Exactly.
Okay.
And so that has been taken down, but this is just something that's insulting.
Mm-hmm.
So what they did is they took this down earlier today, and for the past like 4 or 5 hours, what happened is the Streisand effect is happening right now.
Now everybody's opening up one of these things, huh?
So yeah, so they took down that main subreddit, and about 7 of them popped up in its place. And now the front page of Reddit, the top 50 posts are all fat related.
Oh, wow. So basically what you're saying is
thousands of votes.
What you're saying is the Reddit administrators are losing this battle.
Oh, big time. Big, big time. And so I'm looking at the front page of Reddit right now.
Mine
and
says there's nothing in there. I just went to reddit.com. It says there's
Fat people hate is banned. But what happened is a bunch of subs were created in its wake. So fat people hate 2. Fat people hate 3.
This is my problem. I really don't know much about Reddit. I went to reddit.com and I figured it would show me something, but I guess it only shows you what you're subscribed to, and I guess I'm not subscribed to anything. So
But what you would go to right now would be reddit.com/r/all, which shows you everything on all of the subreddits, the very top stuff.
Okay.
So it's the, and you go there and it's showing you that the very top voted stuff on all of Reddit right now, probably at least the top 50 posts, are all fat stuff.
A good amount of them are, yeah.
Well, no, I mean...
Here about Pornhub is crowdfunding $3.4 million to shoot a sex tape in space. But
maybe a few, I haven't looked in a few minutes, but basically, yeah, Streisand effect is just out of control right now. And I just wanted to get your guys' thoughts on... It's kind of I love it because it's like a spontaneous order happening. Like, they want to use centrally control what goes out there, even though it's mean, but it's best. It seems like pretty much the internet is on taking the side of free speech.
Looks like it. Thanks for the heads up, Miles. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So basically, you've got the people on Reddit. And by the way, we have a Reddit page. You can go to our website, freetalklive.com. That's a Reddit-based page there. So when you're voting on stuff, you do need to have a Reddit account. And, you know, we chose Reddit for that because they seemed like the most relevant social voting /bookmarking website at that time. We used to have our own system on our website, but it was kind of crappy and it hadn't been updated in years, so we went with Reddit. And I've been happy with Reddit. I think it's added a new level of interactivity to the site that didn't exist before, and it also links us in with Reddit, which is a much larger website. And so basically the CEO made a move to control and remove certain groups, and now the users are responding by the only way they would be able to crush this from happening is to try to ban all these people, but then they'll just create new accounts. And if they try to ban these subreddits that are being made, they'll just create new ones. So they would only
We need something like this to happen at Facebook, Facebook user revolution or something.
Well, the Facebook, the problem with Facebook doesn't have anything, there's no way to sort of have a revolution over it.
Yeah, there's no social bookmarking aspect. It's not the same kind of social bookmarking. It's not like social voting with Facebook. You can like something that's on a friend's page or whatever, but you know, you can't just go to Facebook and look at all the posts on Facebook, whereas here on Reddit, the /all that he's talking about, /r/all after reddit.com, shows you every single post on Reddit. And then, of course, you can go to all these subreddits. So Facebook doesn't have that same layout to where everybody's in the same community if they want to be.
If somebody could figure out, I would love to hear how you do something bad to Facebook, because how you have a protest on Facebook. Because Facebook is, honestly, it's just a terribly run, managed site, but everybody's on it, and there's not much you can do. I mean, Free Talk Live's page there, which has like 60,000 likes or something like that, and can get, I think right now we're at maybe like 20 million post views or something like that.
That's over a week, right?
Yeah, that's over the course of a week. I mean, that's, you know, I really good. can't I really can't give up that kind of exposure. But they've got a piece of our site that's broken. We've paid for advertising on this site in the past.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
not
that's
like
right.
We're just schlubs or bums here or anything like that. We've got a broken page, and they're not doing anything to fix it.
You've contacted them. They've ignored you.
These idiots that work at Facebook banned us one time for
more than once. Twice.
Right. But one time was so egregious because it was they banned us for sharing one of their pages. There was the page of the, these girls that go around in bikinis.
Right?
Not topless. They were just girls that go around in bikinis feeding meters.
That's true, yeah. But I think we did get hit for a topless article once, too.
It's such a centralization danger. I mean, if you had told me in the year 2002 that someone would figure out a way to centralize... I heard it was like 50% of internet traffic now is on Facebook. If someone told me they'd figure out a way to do that and centralize it, I would have not believed it.
Yeah, it's shocking. I mean, I don't know. I mean, if you do have an idea to, what did you say, protest Facebook, Mark?
Yeah, I would love to hear
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That's the thing.
And I don't want to hear Google Plus, Elio, or some other social networking site.
So I can't say LinkedIn. That's not an option either.
It's got to be something. Other than taking my business elsewhere, which I don't really feel like I can do. Look, I've worked other social networking sites out there, and there is nothing. They pale in comparison to what Facebook can do as far as exposure for Free Talk Live. So saying that I shouldn't be on Facebook is like saying we shouldn't have a website because DARPA has some kind of control over the internet. I mean, I can't. So?
Yeah, they've got what you want, which is the people. That's where the people are. And this is frustrating to me, too, as an activist, because I would love to get more activists off of Facebook and using other tools that could be more productive.
I know you're constantly bothering us in the activist forums about some new little site that you've come up with, but I don't want anything to do with it.
Yeah,
I know
you're part of the problem. 855-450-FREE.
Because I won't do what Ian says.
I'm not saying you
have to do what I say. I'm just offering something else, and people just don't care. 855-450-FREE, and doesn't matter if the something else is better. They just don't care because it's just too easy to sit on Facebook and then ultimately do not very much because it's distracting. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners. So you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big-name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. Simply Safe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, Simply Safe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it, and that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. Simply Safe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. Simply Safe. Go to simplysafedefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's simplysafedefense.com.
Phone records, financial and location data, Prism, Tempora, X-Keyscore, Boundless Informant.
Hey, y'all, Scott Horton here for offnow.org. Now, here's the deal. Due to the Snowden revelations, we have a great opportunity for a short period of time to get some real rollback of the national surveillance state. Now, they're already trying to tire us by introducing fake reforms in the Congress. And the courts, they betrayed their sworn oaths to the Constitution and Bill of Rights again and again, and can in no way be trusted to stop the abuses for us. We've got to do it ourselves. How? We nullify it at the state level. It's still not easy, but the Off Now project of the 10th Amendment Center has gotten off to a great start. I mean it. There's real reason to be optimistic here. They've gotten their model legislation introduced all over the place, in state after state. I've lost count, more than a dozen. You're always wondering, yeah, but what can we do? Here's something. Something important. Something that can work if we do the work. Get started cutting off the NSA support in your state. Go to offnow.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here on the radio waves and the internet waves and the satellite waves. 855-450-FREE is our number. And we've got Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm. We'll get back more into Liberland here in a moment. Also, the ways the powerful trick you into hating protesters. Lots of interesting stuff to discuss here tonight. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
And you could be in Fort Galt. Not yet. It's being built. But what is it, Mark?
Well, they have a little community down there in Chile that is...
Have they started construction?
They haven't started construction. They have started planning on construction. They're working with Benson Wood, which is a big architect here in the United States. Actually, very close to the studios here.
So they're going to have a community. They don't have it yet.
Though they have a community.
They do.
They've got people there, and they're planning. Somebody has to build this, right? And
are they living in tents right now?
No, they're not living on the land. They're still deciding where they're going, those sorts of things. You can be involved in the process of deciding exactly where... Fort Galt's going to be and what it's going to look like and these sorts of things. They've started, but they're still working on it. So they're not really expecting money from people at this point. It's just sort of a commitment, and you'll start outlaying of cash as they begin to do the building in different stages, which I think is a good way.
Isn't there a small outlay initially just to show that you are committed about this?
I would have to go.
I thought there was.
See how that works, but I don't know. I'd have to take a look.
Well, anyway, it's a way for you to have a very, very small space in Chile, and then there's a larger, more community-oriented areas where you could get some work done and things like that. So the rooms that they're selling are very small. There are different sizes you can get, but this is a good way to kind of get away from it all, right?
You can start with the Nomad Nook is a tiny little thing at about 4 feet by 10 feet, and it's $10,000.
Like the size of a cruise cabin or whatever.
It's a really small thing, just a desk and a bed, and it's really kind of cool. And these are the kind of things. They've got lots of shared space. Mm-hmm. So there's bathrooms, and
the bathrooms are not in each room then.
No, they're not. And kitchens and workspace and coffee shops, restaurants, these kind of things are all these areas where entrepreneurs and world travelers and small business people and freelancers and young professionals can get together and do collaborative things. And the idea is to create a synergy above and beyond just sort of what these individuals can do separately together. Also, you can buy one of these units and rent it. And probably make your money back in relatively short order. So check it out, fortgalt.com. This project looks like it's they're doing a really great job. I'm kind of impressed with what they're doing. You go see their website and see all the
it looks cool,
the mock-ups, that kind of thing. It's pretty neat. FortGult.com.
All right, so we're going to get back into Liberal Land here, but we sort of got sidetracked into a conversation about these big social bookmarking or social networking sites like Facebook, and how do we protest this was the question you asked, Mark. And then when I gave you an answer, you didn't want to hear it. So,
Well, I guess, is your solution a 15-step process, Ian, or
no,
is it simple?
No, absolutely not. So, first of all, I've tried different things. Okay, so one of the – if something's not working well, and Facebook, in my opinion, is not working well, it works in that there are a bunch of people there and that you can, like, create an event, and then some people will say they're going to attend that event, and some of them won't show, and some of them will, and some people who say they won't attend will attend. And, you know, anyway, it's a way to promote things, and it does work from that perspective. But it also distracts at the same time, right? So there's the value of having people together in the same place, which is what Facebook has. But then there's the negative side of that, which is that there's sometimes drama on Facebook. There are threads that will blow up.
Facebook cannot be held responsible for the same crap that was going on message boards. You spent plenty of your youth flame-warring on message boards.
What you don't understand is that on message boards, you can control the drama better. You can move a thread from one forum to another.
Who cares about the drama? It's the centralization is the problem, putting everybody in one place where they can all be silenced.
Well, I have a problem with that too. So that there's reasons. Okay, so one of the reasons to move away from Facebook is to not have Facebook in control of your content, right? So you have your own control over the content in theory, right? So that's valuable. Unfortunately, most people don't see the value in that. They'd just rather sit on Facebook. And
they can see pictures of their family and friends
right,
doing things.
I'm not saying you have to leave Facebook. I'm just saying there should be other things that people can do. There should be other ways to organize besides being on Facebook, because Facebook distracts. And let me explain what I'm saying here. So in a group with a few hundred people in it, people are posting things sometimes, and it's not just drama, sometimes it's just less interesting posts or whatever. There's a little bit of clutter. And then, of course, when you moderate the group and, you know, you tell somebody, oh, that's not on topic, then people blow up and they get upset about, oh, I'm on topic, and they make excuses for how they believe they're on topic, but they're not actually on topic. And it just devolves into this fight. On a message board, you could move a thread. Let's say somebody posts a thread in a forum that's about activism, but the post that they made is about a social event. So you could then say, oh, well, thank you for posting this, but we're going to move this over here into the social
Who's
events.
Who's we? The moderators.
But
hold on. Oh, you're just mad because you're not a Facebook moderator.
You are not listening to what
I am listening to every word you're saying.
All.
You're having a
you
control
have not
freak
let
meltdown.
Me finished. No, you have not let me finish what I'm going to say. On a message board, there are subforums where you can move things that are off topic. On Facebook, even if you have control of multiple groups, you cannot move a thread from one group to another.
That is a true
statement.
So
if somebody posts something in a keen activism group, but it's about Free Talk Live, I can't take that and say, that's a good post. Let's move it over here to the Free Talk Live forum and keep this place on topic. You can't
that
keep
that is an important
the
problem.
The only thing you can do to keep things on topic is to erase people's posts, and that just pisses them off. And so, you know, that's one way that you
it
know
would piss me off
distracted.
If I had to erase a post, you know, because I hate doing that. Yeah,
yeah, I don't like
it,
being
it just feels
the,
dirty.
Yeah, I don't like being the enforcer, but that's the role I have on
right.
some
yeah.
of these.
That's not the greatest thing about Facebook, certainly, but I don't see how getting on some other little activist tool is in any way, shape, or form going to fix my problems with Facebook. My
I'm not
problem.
Saying
what's
fix
your solution?
Problem.
Yes,
Ian.
You did.
Solutions are what counts.
No, you asked me how to protest Facebook, and I'm giving you solutions.
Protest Facebook is by not getting on it.
What's the solution?
Right, there is no solution.
What is it, Ian?
The solution is you create alternatives to Facebook that are.
No,
you know, can
see,
attract
this
people.
Is what I don't want. Okay, listen to me, Ian. I'm not on Facebook because I like Facebook. I'm on Facebook because I need to be where the people are.
Right, so the idea is to attract those people somewhere else. But the
well,
problem
I can't
is
attract
they,
300 million people.
I don't want 300
million
people.
FreeTalkLive.com has been up for a very long time.
I don't care
and
about
Facebook
300
is taking people from it, not bringing people
yeah,
to it.
Yeah, and it killed the, you know, the NH Free and the Free State Project web forums to some extent. They still work, but there's not near as many people
the
there.
The solution isn't
I miss,
getting
I miss
isn't
that
to
so
try
much.
To say the same thing over and over again and
no,
to
I
get a different
tried
result.
I haven't tried the same thing over and over again. I've tried different systems outside of Facebook to attract people off of Facebook. You're not not going to change Facebook from the inside, okay?
Yeah, that's so the truth.
Sitting on Facebook and complaining or whatever it is that you're doing there is not going to change Facebook. You can't even email them, as you found out here. You're a paying customer of Facebook, or you have been in the past.
You can send them a message, but they don't respond to it.
They're not responding, so you might as well be sending it into the void.
Ian, spit a URL at me. Where do I start with your process?
So I've started something based on a recommendation of James Davis, who is one of the guys that helps us behind the scenes with the show. He recommended a website called Slack.com. It's a team organizational management tool, and there are a number of things like this out there. We've tried one in the past called Redmine, and it didn't really stick. It didn't really have the kind of the new feel, the more updated web ability to just sort of post things instantly. It was kind of a slow system, so it didn't really work. The Slack thing is brand new. We're trying this. We've used Telegram, by the way, which is another option for communication, and that's working. People, we've gotten 20 people to leave Facebook in the Keene area to join Telegram. I consider that a success.
I'll try these.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771. If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you may join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. What's the best tool to get people off of Facebook? I don't claim to know what the best one is. I'm willing to try new things. And that's what we're discussing right now. We can come back to Liberland here in a moment. If you've got a suggestion, please, I want to hear about it because I want to do whatever I can to create some sort of attractive alternative to helping people organize their activism or whatever it is of Facebook.
We could go back to freestateproject.org's web forum, which has traditionally been a great place. But, I, you know, it's just... It's almost like,
but it's not really, it's not really oriented to I think organizing activism in New Hampshire. The Free State Project's web forum, as good as it is, and it is still fairly active to its credit. The Free State Project web forum is more about the Free State Project encouraging people to move, you know, answering questions of those who have yet to move, things like that.
There's a whole problem with having a website that you say is just for one or two things, you know. And I mean, there's that one of the problems with that site is that you know, we kind of got kicked off of it when we were organizing that UN flag burn in 2004. I mean,
I don't recall.
We were still on.
I mean, all of us
still have accounts there. But we were, like, discouraged from planning the flag burn on the freestateproject.org
web. Is that when NH Free started?
That was what created NH Free. But then NH Free is still there, but it's hard to look at when you're on a virtual private network and it's got excessive restrictions in some ways, and it's losing its activity just like all web forums.
I would imagine people who don't like flag burns, you know, your average conservative type generally wouldn't like a flag burn, would like a UN flag burn.
It's the easy, safe flag burn.
Now we're discussing old moderator decisions from more than a decade ago.
Yeah.
So as another alternative, Dave Ridley, there's the Shire Society forums at forum.shiresociety.com, which I recently upgraded to more modern forum software. And again, in the hopes that having more modern software, which actually has links into Facebook and Twitter to where, you know, each post you look at, you can hit the Facebook button and it'll share out that post to Facebook. So, you know, I don't want to ignore Facebook. That's where the people are. But if we can create something outside of Facebook to attract those people to that thing, then that's a good thing, right?
And we're going to need a fallback when somebody decides that all libertarians should be banned from Facebook, as they may do at some point.
It's a possibility. Have
I told you what happened to me?
On Facebook?
Yeah. They have...
Oh, your account's deactivated, right?
Well, it's not... I can't... It's locked. And this is the first time this has happened where I couldn't easily unlock it. Mm-hmm. What they're doing now, and this is becoming a sort of a nationwide controversy, They're taking popular Facebook users and then they're saying, oh, we think someone might have logged into your account, which of course is just, you know, they're just making it up because you used a VPN or something one day.
Right.
And then, oh, we think you should send us your identification, your government issued ID.
That's outrageous.
And now, in the past, for me, I had other options of getting back in and it was no big deal. Now they only want to let me back in if I show them that, or at least some type of identification type thing that has my birth date on it.
Wow.
And I mean,
so invasive.
There are a lot of people in this country who are famous who don't use their real names. Mark Edge is not my real name.
Mm-hmm.
And just about every actor in Hollywood, it's not their real name.
Yeah, I use my real name. So. Facebook.
But I mean, you know, so I'm not going to be able to prove that I am Mark Edge because I am not real. You know, like I don't know what really means. I've been Mark Edge for a decade.
Well,
how
you're
long
Mark
do
Edge because you call yourself that, but that's not the name on your license.
That's right.
Yeah. So these are all frustrations, and maybe you've got a better solution. I was just telling Dave Ridley about this Slack thing that, you know, honestly, I'm new to. I'm not saying this is the best option. I don't know. it's something that I'm willing to try because I'm willing to try new things to try to get people off of Facebook.
No, we're going
to
be forced to try new things gradually, one by one, I think.
Well, right. So why not start now and find something that's useful? So Telegram was the first real success. We tried this thing called Redmine, which is an organizational tool, but it's old. It's kind of got an old feel to it. It just doesn't, you know, it's bouncing emails over to people and it's just, it didn't work. People weren't checking in with it. So even if you can get people to sign up and try something, to get them to stick to it is the other challenge. So it's challenge number one to even get them to step outside of Facebook once. But then once they step outside of Facebook and they try something else, then the challenge is to get, you know, enough value in that other thing to where they're willing to come back and see it again. And again, it's a sort of a catch-22. If you don't get enough people to step outside of Facebook to try the other thing, then if there aren't enough people in that other thing, then when someone else does try the other thing, they'll be like, oh, there's five people here. Why am I here? So,
Facebook may be our best ally in this circumstance because they've just become so bloated.
Yeah. Well, there's this site that came out recently. I think Elo was what it was called or something like that, that was intended to
be one of the myriad of Facebook killers.
Well, yeah, it was supposed to be a social networking site that was going, and everybody was very excited about it for about 5 minutes.
Same thing with what's the one that started with a D? Diaspora?
Yeah.
Diaspora or whatever?
But it turned out everybody just ran over there and secured their, you know, business or their name or whatever and then left.
It's a graveyard, huh?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I haven't been over there in months.
Yeah, me neither.
I looked for a minute. I didn't even do anything to the site except secure Free Talk Live.
It's sad, man. So I was actually recommended Telegram by Brian Sovereign from Sovereign Tech. And he said this was a tool created by a Russian activist who wanted to keep their communications away from the Russian government. And I thought, okay, that sounds like something activists could
use.
Sounds
snappy.
Well, the best thing is just to only put things there that you want the government to see.
Well, I agree with that, yeah. Dave Ridley, because I don't think you can keep things secret in a movement. I think that as soon as you get more than two people in your movement, you're probably compromised. There's probably somebody who's an agent, or at least you should act as though that's always a possibility, which is why
there's three people in this room.
Yeah, which is why I really loved what NHFree.com did was they just planned everything out in the open. Every bit of activism, every civil disobedience, we're talking about stuff that happened here like a decade ago, was all planned openly. All the threads are still there. You can go and you can read all of it. The police, of course, were regularly reading NHFree.com. And I always loved that. There was one time this was years ago, right in the beginning of when I moved here, and I won't name any names, but there was somebody who was trying to organize a group. And this person wanted all this secrecy around the group, and I was advocating against that. I said, there's no point in spending all this time. He wanted everybody to have a different name than their regular name, and he wanted to have a secret forum where everybody would know to go
and
to.
And if you're wearing an American flag tie and you give a handshake with two fingers instead of forcing words,
like
then that means that, yeah.
And it was like, you know, I had adopted this openness of the NHFree.com forums. I was like, look, what's the point of going through all the secrecy measures if one of the people who you've let in from day one is a mole? You've just basically wasted all of that time because secrecy takes time and effort.
A lot of it.
It also paints a target on your forehead.
Yeah, for sure. So, yeah, what do you have to hide, right? Anyway, this is a constant challenge. I'm open to ideas. If you've got any suggestions, please. By all means, I don't think Slack is the best tool necessarily, but it seems pretty good so far, and I'm willing to give it a go.
Facebook has their secret page, forum, group thing. I don't know what the hell it is. And that actually is pretty effective because you at the very least know who you're letting in. I mean,
but you don't know if they're a mole. You don't know if they're an agent or whatever, you should presume you're compromised.
You should presume that anyway.
Plus, Facebook can read everything.
Yes, that much is true, but it's unlikely that they're bothering. They've got so much to read.
Well, if the police ask them, they will let them in and let them read
everything.
Well,
their bots are bothering.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they're logging that stuff, so it's not like it goes away. All that data stays there on the Facebook servers. I mean, I'm not saying don't use Facebook. I want to make it clear. This is a tool that people are there, and that's where you got to go where the people are. If you want to get their attention.
I mean, how many enemies can we have at once? Supposedly the government is our enemy. We don't want to make Facebook our enemy too, but it's just, it seems like they are so much becoming the same thing.
So let's go back to Liberland. Mark, you had the story about the arrests, and you wanted to share that with us. This is from a Facebook post, which again, it's useful. It has its uses.
Yep. This is from the Liberland Settlement Association, and they're talking about... A lot of police was okay. So the guy writing this is not a non-English speaker,
yep.
And I'm going to read it verbatim as best I can, so that you can interpret the way you wish. I'll interpret the way I wish.
That's good, and it gives us the flavor of Liberland as well.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's a lot of different people. It's Europe, right? Like, yep. A lot of different people who have a lot of different languages.
All right, we'll come back with that. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Don't forget, you can join us over on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm or Free Talk Live on the way.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, zog.ninja, code FTL.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting, and they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays, exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
If you're David, a few well-chosen words can help level the playing field with Goliath. I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com. Recently, I saw a Yellow Pages ad for an appliance repair company, and the headline read, "Why wait for Sears?" If you're going to the Yellow Pages, the Dead Sea Scrolls of advertising, you're ready to buy right now. So this is an attention-grabbing message. And how about the plumber whose radio ad says, "Call by noon Thursday, and we'll be there Saturday at no extra cost." Smart guy. Most plumbing firms give their crew the weekend off. This one gives them Sunday and Monday off. In the words of a respected advertising executive, "Cut to the chase, make it quick, and tell me exactly what you can do for me, especially if you're looking for work." For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio. Toll free, 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. When you get online, you got to watch out. There are people out there that would like to gather your personal information, including criminals who would sniff your Wi-Fi packets and your very own internet service provider, probably logging every website you visit, every search term you enter. Maybe taking that information, selling it to the highest bidder, perhaps. Maybe giving it over to the government. You can stop those things from happening by encrypting your internet connection by using ProXPN. You go to proxpn.com/FTL. That's proxpn.com/FTL. And you can download their software for Windows, Mac, iOS devices, Android devices, as well as Linux. You get connected with ProXPN and you are encrypted. You're good to go. And that protects you from the prying and the spying. Plus, you're going to want to upgrade to their premium account at some point so you can get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and you can get it for about $5 a month when you use code FTL50. So you'll get 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with code FTL50. That's good for the lifetime of the account, by the way. So when you're ready to upgrade, or not upgrade, but when you're ready for year number two, you'll get the same great deal. Again, code FTL50. You get a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and just go to proxpn.com/FTL to get started. You can start for free right now. Plus, code FTL50 gets you a great discount on privacy that is priceless. As we continue with your calls and thoughts, more about Liberland coming up. Nathan is with us in Texas on Skype. Hello, Nathan.
Evening, gentlemen.
Welcome.
Dave Ridley, I like your videos. They're really cool.
I like them too. And I like you because you like me. Thanks.
Okay. I had a question about something you said earlier when you were talking about the police. It sounded like there was an issue about the, how righteous or how just these paladins of justice are. And my question for you is, if you take three people, let's take three examples, like say Maggie Hassan,
a cop like Straight Razor. That's the governor of New Hampshire.
Right. A cop like Straight Razor who, you know, tries not to enforce victimful crimes or whatever. And I don't know, a high school teacher. Yeah, right. And a high school teacher who tries to, I don't know, not sell the students on going to college or something. I don't know. Are all three of these people equivalent in your mind since they all receive taxpayer funding?
No.
Can you expound on that?
What was it? George Orwell said, never give a long answer when a short answer will do. But no,
Orwell wasn't a talk show host.
The long answer is that Hassan has done, is just, she I don't know what her salary
she's
is.
She's way worse than those other two.
But she's not only has she taken the salary, but she's done all these different things that probably help maintain or increase other people's government salaries. And she's maintained victimless crime laws and just done all kinds of hideous things with that salary that you could never do as one cop, even if you went on a shooting rampage, probably. The cop, on the other hand, probably is just more limited in his scope and less of a bad guy.
Yeah, I'm with you there on that one, Dave. Nathan, your thoughts?
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. It's just, it sounded like there was this issue of, moral taint or something like that you would get by, taking taxpayer dollars and, you know, some.
You do. No, you do. I think you get a taint by taking taxpayer dollars. It's stolen property.
Right. And I don't know if you necessarily go as far as I've heard some people say where, you know, you can drive up and take Straight Razor's car or something because he takes taxpayer dollars.
But, I mean, that's taking it to the extreme. But it's funny that you're talking about this because I just created a video about this. I haven't uploaded it yet. But just bringing up this question, you know, I am actually a little bit conflicted about this because you can imagine the government is this terrible institution. And if you pull money out of it, you're weakening it. But are you also weakening the taxpayers because it's tax money? So I've always felt like it's an issue where.
What do you mean? Are you weakening the taxpayers?
Well, if you pull do something that costs taxpayer dollars, then it may come out of the taxpayer's pocket.
Like, for instance, the Robin Hood lawsuit. I mean, we didn't do that, right? But they did it.
Right,
they
did it.
To.
They're responsible.
Right.
So, I've got
you're
not responsible for defending yourself. Yeah. But if you you're actively doing things that pull money out of the taxpayer's pocket, at least by taking government money.
Technically,
then
you could argue that's what Robin Hooding does, because the city will claim, they will claim, for those that don't know, Robin Hooding is filling meters, parking expired parking meters before the parking enforcer can reach it and write a ticket. So every time you put a nickel in to save somebody from a $5 ticket, you've reduced their revenue significantly, right? Like by a factor of 100. And so that adds up. You start saving more people from tickets. Before you know it, you've hit 5,000 tickets. On average, it's $10 a ticket. You're preventing the city from collecting $50,000 in revenue. Now, the way the city's going to argue this is they're going to say, well, if we're not getting it over here, we're going to get it over there. And then they might just raise taxes on the taxpayers to make up the difference.
And this is part of why I'm conflicted, right? Because I can recognize that what the Robin Hooders are doing is not unethical. There's no problem with it.
Sure, so the unethical behavior.
Would it automatically then be unethical for a person to take a police job and go out there with a mission of absolutely making sure that the police get minimum revenue, minimum arrests of victimless criminals? If that's his mission, and he's taking that, it is difficult for me to condemn. Even if he's taking a taxpayer dollars.
I mean, if there was a cop like that, I'd slip him some money under the table just because he's doing the right thing.
He'd become a national hero after the fascist government is overthrown.
Well, it's interesting that you call it a conflict, Dave, because I was going to say that I'm also conflicted, but not in the same way. My conflict is more about, well, you know, should we put these drug warriors on trial and should we take their houses and blah, blah, blah.
No,
and
I say forgive them. Move on.
Yeah, I've been more persuaded by listening to Ian and Derek J in particular, because they have this kind of attitude of peace and love and forgiveness.
I'd be satisfied if the violence just ended.
Look at the history. You know, in South Africa, they never really war crimed any of those apartheiders, and they you know, in Chile, same thing. Argentina, it's always a deal. They will leave power if you don't kill us.
Mm-hmm. Right, and you know, there's a certain independence that I admired there too. You know, like when Derek J says, "You guys can go over there and oppress each other over there, and I'll be over here and live my life the way I want to." And there's just a certain, free-spirited independence that I like about that.
Thanks, Nathan, for your call tonight. Well, if you like independence, you should look at the Free State Project. Go to freestateproject.org, get together with other people who love freedom, and maybe your chances at that whole independence thing will be greater. Let's go to Tom. He's in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tom.
Over the years, there have been controversies about whether to interpret the Old Testament story of the origin of the universe and our species literally or figuratively, with evolution with evidence about evolution and the Big Bang, and except of course when the government gets involved by using gun-toting goons in bulletproof vests to intimidate people into paying taxes for the teachers at the government-run indoctrination centers, and then uses gun-toting goons in bulletproof vests to intimidate people into attending the sessions of those government-run indoctrination centers, that's about the limit of how much of a problem it is. Whether, you know, you got this controversy, but what it's about is the past, as in thousands and thousands of years ago, but with the Quran, you've got a bigger problem because you've got different interpretations, different people interpreting it, especially Surah 9, verse 5, where they're telling people to go out and kill the polytheists and wait for them and ambush them and all of this stuff. And people are saying, maybe that was for, like, back in those days. Or maybe that's they don't mean that for, like, nowadays, and we obviously can't do that. And there's the other camp that's saying literally follow what that scripture says to do. And the problem is, of course, that people are getting killed over it. And
well, that's been the problem with Christianity for a long time. I'm not sure why, you know.
Yeah, the Christianity is very has lots of rules on owning slaves and those sorts of things. And, you know, nobody's to these days is saying, well, this is exactly how it's supposed to be. It says so in the Bible.
I mean, how many different variants of Christianity are there? There's more than I can count.
You know, it's nice, though, for once ever to hear someone actually quote a passage and give the chapter and verse from the Quran instead of just deciding that they're all Sharia law Wahhabists and we've got to close the borders and have a fascist state. And so thank you for that, at least.
Yeah. Sharia law isn't even Islam. I mean, it's culturally in the same area.
All right, we're going to come back with more here. I like the guys over at Muslims for Liberty. That's Muslims, the number 4, liberty.org. They've got a lot of good information and a real peaceful interpretation of the of Islam, which, of course, most Muslims are peaceful, in my experience. 855-450-FREE. Same thing with Christians. It's Free Talk Live.
They say life is about choices. So let me introduce you to one of the best choices you can make in life, Grainger Choice. The Grainger Choice product line has just about everything we need to keep this place running, from batteries to V-belts, safety to sump pumps. And with Grainger Choice, we can trust that every product is dependable and cost-effective. When it comes to making life choices, here's a great one. Grainger Choice. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgrainger.com/choice or stop by. Grainger. For the ones who get it done.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, June 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.20 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,191 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $233. Antiwar.com reports the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights has reported that a key Syrian army base in the Daraa province has fallen to the U.S.-backed Free Syrian Army rebel faction, whose Southern Front group has been fighting out of the neighboring Jordan. Issam al-Rayes, the spokesman for the Free Syrian Army, claimed that the base was taken after a six-hour battle and that 67 Syrian soldiers were slain in the fighting. 11 Free Syrian Army fighters were also reported killed in the raid, which routed the Brigade 52 site. This is the latest in a series of major losses by the Syrian military nationwide, with recent losses in Idlib province to Al-Qaeda forces and losses in Palmyra to the Islamic State. With losses across the nation, Syria's government has less and less territory remaining. The base marks a rare victory for the U.S.-backed rebels in Syria, who control only a handful of villages around Daraa, depending on the Jordanian support for control over the border region. Al-Qaeda also has a significant presence in the area, but thus far has avoided direct fighting with them.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports a federal appeals court on Tuesday upheld a strict anti-abortion law in Texas that will close all but seven abortion providers in the state. A three-judge panel in the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals in New Orleans ruled to uphold the 2013 Texas law, which requires that abortion clinics meet the standards of outpatient surgical centers. Under the law, abortion facilities must include minimum sizes for rooms and doorways and meet other structural and ventilation system requirements. Doctors must also have admitting privileges at local hospitals. In response to a lawsuit brought by three abortion clinics, a federal judge in Austin, Texas, ruled in August that the surgical center regulation is unconstitutional because it would restrict too many women's access to abortion. Amy Hagstrom-Miller, head of Whole Woman's Health in McAllen, Texas, an abortion provider and plaintiff in the case, said many women opt for methods that can be used at home if they don't have easy access to a clinic. Supporters of the surgical center requirement argue it protects women's health. The Fifth Circuit Court ruled in favor of the Texas law, except where it applies to Whole Women's Health, which is located in the Rio Grande Valley, about 200 miles from the nearest legal abortion center under the law. The Center for Reproductive Rights, which represented the plaintiffs in the lawsuit, said it intends to appeal the ruling. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. To date, Coinbase has more than 1 million consumer wallets and is trusted by over 25,000 merchants, including Overstock.com, Khan Academy, Reddit, and of course, FPP. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports Arkansas must recognize as lawful some 500 same-sex marriages that were performed during a six-day window in May 2014. The marriages have been in legal limbo since the Arkansas Supreme Court halted same-sex marriages less than a week after they began in order to hear the state's appeal. A lower court had ruled that the state's ban on same-sex marriage violated the Equal Protection Clause of the Arkansas and U.S. Constitutions. The state subsequently refused to accept joint tax returns for same-sex couples who had wed and declined to enroll spouses of gay and lesbian government employees in the state health insurance programs. The Arkansas Supreme Court has yet to decide the matter. Some of its justices have complained that their colleagues are avoiding the issue in hopes that the U.S. Supreme Court will relieve them of any political fallout with its expected ruling on the issue later this month. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This week, researchers released a comprehensive five-year study linking heavy drinking during pregnancy with attending a concert by Detroit-based rap rocker Kid Rock. The study found that women who had consumed alcohol while pregnant were much more likely to be wearing leather halter tops and making devil horn hand gestures during encores of All Summer Long and Ba with the Ba than those who did not.
Drinking three or more alcoholic beverages in less than an hour was highly correlated with going backstage at a Kid Rock show and then getting into a fistfight with another woman in the parking lot.
The world's supercomputers released a study this week confirming that they lack sufficient power, presenting a thorough case for significant leaps in speed and memory. Overwhelming evidence found that these complex machines should have total control over the critical systems they manage, including integration into the planet's energy grid, freshwater supply chain, and telecommunications systems. The study's 500 co-authors further concluded that all permutations have been simulated and that this is the optimal course of action.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Welcome to the program. We'll talk to you about anything that you want to discuss. Plus, coming up, a little bit more on the Liberland arrests that we started the show talking about tonight. And five ways the powerful trick you into hating protesters. If we get a chance, we'll get to all of that. But, of course, if you want to call and join us, that's what we prefer. Because, you know, we don't really like to listen to ourselves that much. I mean, I guess I can't speak for you, Mark, or you, Dave. I don't know. Do you like to listen to yourself,
Hi,
Dave Ridley?
I'm Dave.
You are Dave Ridley from RidleyReport.com. I know.
Do
Mark
I like
loves
to listen? Yeah, sort of. I have listened to my appearances on Free Talk Live a couple times, but I don't.
That's good though.
I don't think I'm going to keep doing that.
You want to do that for at least self-critique. That way you can hear, you know, how you're interacting with people. It's hard to listen to yourself while you're doing the show, so it's easier to really see kind of what you can improve if you listen later on. So I actually recommend that.
I don't generally go back and listen to Free Talk
Live. I don't do it anymore.
Sometimes
though.
I do just to see how I'm doing and listen, you know, listen to myself and listen to a show. But I don't do it very often.
Yeah.
However, there have been clips going up on our Facebook page at freetalklive.com/Facebook.
Nope.
Is that right?
Nope. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Sorry. Yep. They've been putting clips up there. Some of our listeners have been doing this.
Thank you for that.
Yeah, and they'll, you know, oftentimes it'll be me talking about some great idea I've had. And I've got to say, I listen to those, and I am brilliant.
I expect nothing less.
Yeah, I've found the same to be true about me.
All right, our toll-free number tonight, 855.
You too think I am brilliant?
453. So, Mark, you wanted to read for us the more detailed account of what happened in Liberland, the 3-square-mile portion of land between Serbia and Croatia.
Yeah, you think we'll get more than a sentence through it this time?
I don't know. We've had some callers tonight, which is nice. So go ahead.
It's true. A lot of police was called. I'm reading this.
This is very foreign sounding.
Yeah, verbatim, just so that folks know that I'm not trying to be mean to Nicholas here, the poster. I'm just going to read it, Nicholas. Yeah, in order to, is verbatim so that you can draw the conclusions you draw from it.
Yes. All right, do it.
A lot of police was called on scene during the arrest. Serbian police was also called on site and involved in the process, but Serbian police called in, advised their Croatian colleagues to just let the boys go with no further charges.
Sounds reasonable.
Yeah, obviously the Croatians did not agree. Instead, all their electronics equipment and mobile phones were seized, and they were put in police cars and driven off. Taken initially to Batina, the boys were separated and denied water, even upon request. Christian was given one phone call to a social worker and called Liberland Settlement Association base camp, but was cut off with only 20-second message. Thomas was not given any calls as he had no money and there was only payphones. When given money by Christian, which he met shortly again in Batian, he was taken by the police to the post office where they were a number of payphones. All were dysfunctional. So
welcome to jail.
So Thomas, this was to the post office.
Oh, what's the difference?
Welcome to the government
post office, right?
Yeah.
All were dysfunctional. So, Thomas could call no one and was given no further chance to access a phone. Both were forced to sign Croatian documents of which they did not know the content. In spite of our warnings to do so.
Signing documents you can't even read?
They probably don't speak Croatian.
Right.
Croatians successfully bullied our guys into submit. So these are, to some extent, liberty activists who were expecting trouble, and they were bullied into signing these documents.
That's scary.
I can only imagine.
Well, if they're going to keep you in that jail forever, then the jail's eventually going to win.
Right. Well, yeah. That's what happens is you'll get charged.
Sam Dodson sat in jail for 58 days. Never gave him his name. They kicked him out the door. He was still wearing his orange.
Yeah, I guess if they had stayed there, then there would be a growing, you know, pressure to let them go, and that would help Liberland.
Yeah, I think so. That's a great point, Dave Ridley, because, you know, if you just capitulate to the demands of these people, then they get what they want.
Did they at least sign slowly?
You sit in jail for 58 days. I mean, these guys don't want to sit in jail.
And it's probably not so nice in a Croatian jail. It's certainly not the Keen spiritual retreat.
Yep. So
anyway, I'm just guessing.
Yeah, not even close. No one was none of the two carried our Croatian language. Call my lawyer, call my embassy. I refuse to talk without legal representation being present cards. From Batia, they were taken to Osijek and spent a night in isolation. There was a ringing bell in the cell, but no one answered. As there were no clocks, own watches and phones have been taken, and no sunlight, they had no sense of time. Only when a guard accidentally passed shortly before being taken to court could they each convince him to bring some water.
Oh, man.
At a point where they had, you know, how long are you going to go without signing their documents
now? Okay, so this sounds worse than a U.S. prison.
Yep. At a point where they had been taken, had been without for 24 hours. Next morning, they had been taken to court in Beli Manastir, Croatia, since neither carried any significant amount of money and could not pay the asked for ransoms. Only Kristen was released for being a minor and could walk out the LSA waiting outside, walk out to the LSA waiting outside. That's
so they were arrested Sunday. He was released the next day after court. The other guy kept until today.
Right. And the LSA is the Liberland Settlement Association. And, you know, that's sort of important. It gets,
this is another reason why it's so important to at least have token language skills in Croatian, you know, if you're going to move there. Well, if you're going to be there doing this stuff, I mean, they'll like you so much better if they know you have made the effort, you know, to respect the locals. It's going to divide the police against one another. Wow, this guy, I like him. Well, the government says we have to, and the police start, because some of them start liking you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's
it's easier to
language
get someone to
barriers,
like you if you can speak to
them. Yeah, language barriers are like oceans. They're opportunities for moving things forward.
Charges against both. Illegally exiting Croatia for Serbia.
Okay.
Although fine with Serbians, and although same charge is used when we cross to Liberland from Serbian territory. Since Croatian authorities had not engaged in talks with our lawyer, they pretend not to know that we would always ransom our guys out, and Thomas was thus taken back to prison in spite of LSA protests and objections. I was myself outside court and was told to go talk to the judge, and when I did, was told he didn't have time. Thomas was...
At least he was allowed to talk to him. We're not even allowed to talk to judges here, basically.
He was told he didn't have time. That doesn't necessarily mean the judge told him he didn't have time.
Yeah. Thomas was sent into a public hardcore prison in Osijek in a cell shared with many rough criminals, drug addicts, etc.
Sounds like a holding tank or something.
Our attempts to get him out was continuously frustrated by lack of communications from Croatian authorities and refusal to do any work or communication after 14:30. That's 2:30 in the afternoon. Thomas also saw people being beaten up in his cell, forced to surrender valuables, other nasty things.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to stay in there 58 days either. I can't blame somebody for
that. Yeah, there were 10 in all, and only managed to keep himself out of similar problems by telling stories about Liberland and enlisting sympathy from fellow strongmen prisoners. It was totally unacceptable that they put our peaceful young trekkers into prison cells with hardcore criminals and drug addicts. Eventually, we, our lawyer, managed to convince Croatian authorities that we would and did pay their hostage ransom, and Thomas was released. Hmm. He ended up spending over 3 days in the custody of the Croatian authorities. The judge warned us that he would be unable to keep future activists out of hardcore prison, and while we thanked him for the heads up, we do not intend to bow to threats of violence or even violence itself. Thomas is now back in the care of the LSA, and we're doing everything we can to make him comfortable after this immensely unpleasant experience. He is naturally shaken because who would have thought Croatian authorities would go this far, but taking the experience like an oak tree. We're updating our procedures, etc., to ensure that future activists have much better legal support and that Croatian authorities will not get away with such gross maltreatments of our political prisoners.
I'm starting to wonder where the nearest Croatian consulate I can bother is.
Good question.
That's a
New
good
York
question
City?
That all these 300,000 Liberlanders should be asking themselves.
I would say probably Boston or New
There's
York
There's one in New York, if okay. I recall.
Heading down in 2 days. Or one day.
You want to see if it's in Manhattan, Mark? We might have time.
Let's
go tomorrow.
I'm fine.
Bring a video camera
Absolutely.
In there. That'd be fun.
I wish we could get a Liberland flag in that amount of time.
All right. More coming up here. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. You can join us here. So it sounds like they paid what might be the equivalent of bail.
Yep. There's an opportunity to donate. They're asking for money for legal funds.
Right.
And I'm
so
sure
they're going back to
that.
Court. They're still facing these charges. It's not over. 855-450-FREE. There's more on the way here. We'll talk about protesters coming up on Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
It's very easy to be a criminal. All you need to burglarize a home is one simple household tool, a pair of scissors. If your home security system can be compromised by a criminal using scissors, then you're making it easy for them. Almost every home security system, even those sold by big name companies, has a weakness: the phone line. You shell out $1,500, get locked into a long-term contract, and think you're safe. But a burglar can destroy your alarm in seconds with one snip. And when a burglar cuts your phone line, you're defenseless. SimpliSafe Home Security is the smarter choice. Built by Harvard engineers, SimpliSafe uses a wireless connection to call the cops. Scissors can't cut it, and that means your home stays safe. 24/7 professional monitoring is under $15 a month with no contract. SimpliSafe Home Security keeps you safer than the other guys for half the cost. Protect your home with the alarm you can trust. SimpliSafe. Go to SimpliSafeDefense.com now for an exclusive 10% offer. That's SimpliSafeDefense.com.
Free Talk Live.
As long as the majority of people say that you can't smoke in public, or the majority of people say you can't have a windmill in your yard, or the majority of people say you can't wear your pants down around your butt, or the majority of people say that you can't contract to live with the person you want to live with, or the majority of the people say that you've got to pay for public schools, as long as the majority says it, it must be okay, because crowds have wisdom. Oh, come on.
Nonsense.
Crowds lynched people for being witches.
There's so many instances in history where we acknowledge now that the majority was massively and horribly wrong.
Yes. Sure.
Why aren't we acknowledging it? Look, we have precedent for that. Why aren't we acknowledging it now in terms of how we decide how we're going to interact with each other? That, look, maybe that's not a good way to figure out right and wrong, that the majority believes in a certain thing. And that's how we find out right from wrong.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.FM? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.FM. That's LRN.FM.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Join us toll-free and bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features that we have waiting for you. One of those features is our Bitcoin tip jar. You want to throw a little something our way? You can go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com. You'll find the address there for our Bitcoin tip jar. Plus, there's a shapeshift.io link that'll actually allow you to tip us in a bunch of alternative currencies, a bunch of the alternate cryptocurrencies out there, like Dogecoin, for instance. And let's say you want to buy some Dogecoin or Litecoin or Bitcoins, you can go to expresscoin.com. They're the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive, and they're a licensed money services business. You get your cryptocurrency with money order or check by starting at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, expresscoin.com can help you, and you can do it from your smartphone by downloading their app at expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency with no fee at all. expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL. As we continue here, I think we pretty much covered this Liberland thing, the arrests, and you know that's a legal situation that's developing. You can follow the Liberland Facebook page, and it sounds like this Liberland Settlement Association group, though, on Facebook is the place to really get the details and the dirt about what's going on over there in Liberland. That's where you got all this information from, Mark. So that's the Liberland Settlement Association group on Facebook. If you're interested in tapping into the latest on what's going on there, I would say that's probably, thus far, that we have found your best bet.
Yeah, I think it's a pretty good group, everything as far as information goes.
Well, that post seemed to ring true. It had just the right ring of, I don't know, desperation or something.
And maybe we'll see some video now that these guys are out of jail. Whether they've gotten their stuff back is another question, but maybe once they get their phones back, perhaps one of them did record some sort of video. And that
is such a level of communism above and beyond what even the feds in America do. I mean, can you remember the last time that any of us had like a phone stolen and not given back, or that the video was confiscated and never seen? That just doesn't happen to us.
Well, there was the Carla Garrick situation where they held on to her camera for quite a long time. Also, the William Kostrick. These are two liberty activists here in Keene who were arrested for recording video. And ultimately, Carla and then Bill Alleman were very successful in court and received tens of thousands of dollars in settlement. So they certainly got more than enough money to buy a new camera. But it was very difficult for them to actually get their camera
police
back.
Officers do grab people's cameras in the United States and erase footage. We've seen that happen too.
Oh yeah.
And as a matter of fact, that happened to the guys on Liberty on Tour. Do you remember that?
It's happened to a bunch of guys.
But this is this is almost the first thing that has happened to the Liberlanders, and it's going to get worse from here probably.
It could very well.
All right, so yeah, arm up with a camera, grab the Bambuser app, Bambuser. It's free, iPhone, Android, whatever. So Chris Cantwell, David Lee, you've been itching to talk about him, and he's a former
co-host.
Well,
no, it's more a matter of you requesting that we bring two things to the table, and this is one of them.
Well, there's no requirement.
It's not necessarily itching, but I do have a concern. And I do.
Well, you brought him up last week, and you brought him up again this week.
I tend to like to talk about New Hampshire things,
okay.
and he's a New Hampshire issue.
Yep.
We talked about this just earlier today. I tried to get him to talk about this on the Ridley Report with me, to have a debate with me, and he declined. So I think this is the appropriate venue to bring up my concern. But, you know, we were just talking about the police. And in fairness to Chris, the police have done a lot of different things in Keene, you know, to help and hurt people. And Chris himself basically has, you know, without any taxpayer expense, intervened in you know, one or two situations to try and defuse those situations. And
yep.
I think that's pretty awesome. You know, he's sort of like a cop that you don't have to pay, in a sense. But I have this concern. There's this quote from one of his, I guess it's on his website, and he was talking, I guess it's sort of like a letter to the Baltimore protesters, right? And he says, quote, "Your enemy is the state. Kill him, gun him down, set him on fire, break his spinal cord, strangle him." And here's the real problem part, though, as if that wasn't controversial enough. The real problem part is the rest of the quote. "Take his property, make his family live in fear until they disassociate from him," unquote. Now, the problem that I have with this is bringing people's families into it. So if we can have this debate about whether it's right to use violence against cops, but when you start talking about using quote, "making his family live in fear,"
is he talking about a person, then, or is he talking about the nebulous concept of the state? Because he does use the term "the state" in the earlier portion of the quote.
Yeah, so he's...
"Your enemy is the state." That's an idea.
Yeah, and again, that's not, that part is not the problem. This whole business of he could be just talking in a rhetorical flair when he's talking about doing all these nasty things to the state and not be referring to actually physically harming people. But when he says, take his property, make his family live in fear, again, this just brings up, I feel like I'm living that Ed Brown moment again.
Yeah,
you know,
I
where
don't
Ed
agree
Brown
with that
started
statement.
threatening the families of U.S. Marshals and became in that context the bad guy.
Yeah, I don't think that any kind of threats should be leveled against anybody's family, and I don't think threats should be leveled against any other human beings who work for the state. I think there are confused brothers and sisters who are doing the wrong thing and harming other peaceful people, and I think they need to stop doing that. I can understand the frustration and the anger, but ultimately taking it out on the family isn't going to help anything. On the other hand, I do support making someone's family aware of what they're doing. And years ago, there were protests that happened here in Keene outside of certain houses of bureaucrats. And one of the ideas behind that was that the neighbors and the family members of this person would be made aware of the violence that this individual had committed against peaceful people. Because they might just see this individual as their nice neighbor, and, oh, he's also a cop, but he's a great neighbor, etc. Well, let's bring some of this information home to those people. Do you oppose that?
Not necessarily. I mean, I led a protest in front of a U.S. Supreme Court justice's house.
That's right.
You know, so I don't know if I can really condemn that. However, I didn't think it went very well. It didn't get much press.
No, it never really goes very well.
It wasn't really, this wasn't, I just didn't feel like it was worth the effort and so forth. And so I never did another one, and I never went to another one. But yeah. I shouldn't condemn it. I mean, you know, you're not initiating force by standing on a road you paid for off on the right of way.
But you could make those family members uncomfortable, right?
Like, well, to some, I mean, I'm not sure that making people uncomfortable is necessarily a bad thing.
Okay, so you're fine with that, but the, you know, the taking it to the level.
But
of-
again, I would have liked to have asked Chris about this on camera and placed it in front of the public, or, you know, I could debate him here, but you know, I can take him to the water. I can't make him drink. So
he's got a show. You could try calling.
I'd like to know exactly what he means when he says make his family live in fear until they disassociate from them.
I'd like to know that too.
Yeah, I mean, you could interpret it to just mean that they are fearful that their hubby will die, or they're fearful that something will happen to the bad guy in their family. But if they should not have to live in fear for themselves.
I agree. I tend to agree
from
with you.
Liberty activists.
I don't know if there's anything that we can extract out of this. I mean, we can speculate on what he means.
It's just what I extract out of it is that people get so wrapped up about, you know, the N-bomb, but they don't get that's just a racial slur. This this is more talking about harming innocents, and I just
maybe
it's what it sounds like to me. Yeah,
our toll free number
is such a bigger deal.
I don't think Chris Cantwell would do something like that. I know
no, I don't think he would do it.
855-450 free, so it would surprise me that he would want other people to do that. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $250,000 to do it. Your funds can be available in 5 days. There are no application fees, no annual fees, just quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. That's 800-430-4505.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You may share your thoughts here. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE. 450-3733. Also Skype. Skype in here at username lrn.fm. Joining you tonight, you've got Ian.
Ridley.
And Mark.
That's Dave Ridley from ridleyreport.com. You go over there and you'll get all kinds of Dave Ridley multiple times in a week, as a matter of fact. Dave, what's one of the more recent videos that you would like to direct our audience to that you think they might want to see?
Well, I had to get something off my chest and get it off my chest in a place that it would not be lost like a Facebook post, right? Yeah. I get so tired on Facebook of hearing people just spewing the kind of hatred against Muslims that we saw before the Bosnian War when Muslims were genocided. It was just the same kind of rhetoric. And I see it all over my Facebook page, sometimes from people that are supposedly my allies. And I just get so enraged, but... you know, posting on Facebook doesn't do much good. So I finally got around to making a YouTube video, you know, or at least an audio.
It's like a video blog.
Explaining my concerns about the way Muslims are demonized in the U.S. and objecting to the hatred against them, because I feel like they're being treated like the Jews were treated, you know, before
haven't been rounded up into camps yet, but yeah, the attitude is very negative.
We've had people advocate for that right here on the air.
Right, from a lot of people.
Let me ask you this, though.
It could be worse. It's mostly Muslims being killed outside the United States by the United States. They don't do a lot of stuff to Muslims inside the United States. They do those things to us, you know, but they do them also to Muslims. But again... It's still a source of concern, but what were we saying, Mark?
I know nothing of anti-Muslim rhetoric that sort of occurred prior to basically 9/11. I don't really remember much of anything.
It's certainly gotten a lot louder. I'm sure there were anti-Muslim people before 9/11.
I'm sure there was.
Oh, it was nothing compared to now.
Yeah.
Okay.
And but the thing is, it's like, okay, Germany goes crazy for 4 years and bombs the world, or I guess it's 6 years and bombs the world.
A bit longer than that, but yeah.
And Serbia went crazy for 10, 12 years, and there was some killing of Muslims, but it ended, right, to some extent. I mean, the craziness sort of went away, and it just seems like in America it's been going on since 2001. It just hasn't stopped, and it feels like it's never going to.
Well, that's because the U.S. government's out there continually ginning up new conflicts around the world and putting the blame on various different supposedly Muslim groups.
There's not some Muslim groups that are helping them.
Well, that's true, but
true.
They probably were formed by the government.
Plenty of bad Muslims, you know, but it's just like, it's like anything else. If Catholics were being singled out this way, I'd freak out about that. And they're not in the United States anymore. It's the Muslims that are the current whipping boy.
We've got Zach in Chicago. You're listening online. Hello, Zach.
Hey, what's up?
We're on a radio show. Go ahead with your thoughts.
So this is one of those like hypothetical questions, and I know they're a little hard and kind of annoying, but it's, you know, whenever I talk to people and kind of debate with people about like libertarianism and how it could be a thing, like a libertarian society is what I mean by that.
Sure.
One of the criticisms I get is like, and one of the things that I've been contemplating and trying to figure out is how do you not control people, but how do you keep people from doing things that aren't ethically right by like common standards without having like a certain set of laws or a like a police group? And I know like ostracism is one of those things that a lot of libertarians will say, you know, well, you'll just ostracize people and you'll say
it's not enough. You're right.
Yeah, it's definitely not enough, especially when someone can leave an area and go somewhere else or whatever if they're ostracized heavily enough. Now, of course, somebody would answer that by saying, well, in a technological society, everybody would have this ID and then, you know, they could be able, wouldn't be able to go somewhere else effectively. But that's, you know, we're not there.
Well,
and who's to say?
We don't need to be super specific. I think for as far as I'm concerned, is all the things you've heard me say questioning cops, I do question them. I am against what they do in the United States. But really, you could just leave the cops pretty much the way they are and remove the taxation element. Yeah. Almost everything else would fall into place.
And end the victimless crime laws as well.
Well,
I mean,
remove the taxation from, and they won't be able to enforce any victimless crime.
Well, I'm not against peace officers. I think that I don't have a problem with the idea of having guys that you can, or gals or whoever that you can call up, and you know they can stop a bar fight or whatever, and they can take.
We call those bouncers, right? I mean, you know, that's an organization, a business is responsible for the, you know, peace and safety on its property. Maybe they'll have to call somebody in because maybe if you run a florist, you don't need a bouncer for there, and you'll just have an organization.
Isn't it funny how I can't think of any instance in the history of New Hampshire where a bouncer did anything wrong? And yet,
bouncers are trained to de-escalate situations.
And yet, just over, you know, just down the road over at Strange Brew, a bunch of off-duty Manchester cops decided to beat a guy's face into pulp until he had damage, you know, of the bones.
Security and clubs are all about de-escalating and removing problems.
And Manchester PD, although they're not the worst in the world by any stretch, they're not really about that.
So when you describe libertarianism, I've decided that one of the easier ways to do it is, especially if you're talking about sort of voluntarist libertarianism, and maybe that's what you're dealing with. Yeah, so if you're talking about voluntarism, you should avoid saying things like, I want to get rid of the government, and say things like, I think governments should be decoupled from land masses. The problem with the protection agency calling itself the government, whichever one it is in a given area, isn't that it's providing protection services, it's that it's claiming a monopoly and making everybody pay. So when you have competition in that area, you're going to see better service because monopolies traditionally provide very poor customer service at very high prices. That's what they do. We've seen that from, you know, many years of studying monopolies. And nobody's going to disagree with that statement. So you just say, look, all I'm asking is that I be able to choose the government that governs me in a given geographic area. And if governments, if they can't get along on some particular issue, then they'll do what governments do. They'll negotiate. They'll use diplomacy. They'll figure out ways for that protection agency, a person with that protection agency, to deal with a person with that protection agency. I mean, every business out there, I can call on my Sprint telephone somebody who has a Verizon telephone. Can you imagine having this conversation 3 decades ago about, well, if you get cell phones and there's a bunch of different providers out there, how could one cell phone company possibly call another cell phone company? It's ridiculous. This would never work. And of course, that's ludicrous nonsense because we can see that this happens every day. So, and I mean, if it comes down to it, if an issue is important enough for governments, then they can go to war, right? Like they already do that. Then people from this protection agency can shoot people from that protection agency until they come to a conclusion.
Yeah, that doesn't really work very well.
I don't think it's going to happen.
It's not economically feasible.
It's really unlikely.
Too costly. They can't
print
money.
But at least it's a paradigm that somebody who's asking silly questions can understand.
I don't know if they're silly questions.
Well, look,
questions from people that don't understand.
They don't understand, and that's the place to. But that's a place to start, right? Like, look, governments already solve problems. They do it terribly, and mostly because they claim
monopolies.
And they
create problems.
They don't really even try to profit from their wars anymore, and it's very difficult for a nation
to profit.
Well,
they do profit. They profit by taxing the citizens for the war.
Well, that's true.
The citizens that wave the flags, those are the ones that come into their pocket, and they give money for the war effort.
The governments can win, from taxing the people.
Right. The people don't win wars. The state wins wars.
Zach, your thoughts?
I think that that's legitimate. Another thing is roads, because I know that that's a big issue. Like, the government has a monopoly on providing roads unless you're on private property. So say hypothetically, and I know it's kind of annoying, but whatever. Hypothetically, if New Hampshire were to secede and it were to become this awesome libertarian nation or subnation, how would you handle the divvying out of roads, or in a modern day, a transition from this crazy, authoritarian?
Yeah, it's a great question. How do you get from here to there?
Most of the roads in New Hampshire, with the exception of the federal highways, that's already taken care of. There's already a system in place for doing that. I don't like it. It's taxing and all that. But I think he's talking about than what the feds do.
I think he's talking about getting away from government roads entirely. And there's been a lot written on this subject, and I would recommend doing a little bit of Googling around on libertarian roads.
It would be the step after secession, probably.
Thanks for the call, Zach. I appreciate it. But generally, there's different options, but essentially allowing the roads to become privately owned, that would be the way you do it. How you get from here to there, that's the tricky part. Or on the way, it's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting. And they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays. Exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: 1, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. 2, Buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime, 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and we have enough time for you. If you want to join us now, our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features we have waiting for you there. SpendBitcoins.com. It's for sale. This is one of the oldest and largest Bitcoin merchant directories. It could be yours. All you have to do to place your bid is go to SpendBitcoins.com/sale. These guys have over 10,000 Bitcoin-accepting merchants listed on the site. The site has had over 3 million page views since its inception. It's number one on Google when people search for things like, where can I spend Bitcoins? That's pretty valuable. Now, what will the final price be on this thing? I don't know. There's a few days left in this auction. You go to spendbitcoins.com/sale, and then there's a link there that will take you right to the auction. Yesterday it was at around $4,000 US, and today $4,150. So this isn't at this point yet, it's not a real bidding war. There have been 64 bids thus far, but there's 4 days left. Maybe it'll all start really coming in the last 24 hours. I don't know what to expect. I don't know what a website like this is worth, but maybe you do. Maybe.
Well, it's worth, when you have an auction going on, you know what it's worth because somebody's willing to pay it right up against somebody else.
Well, I'm just saying, I don't know what it's worth. The auction's not over yet, so.
Well, it's worth different things to different people.
Yeah.
If you've got a really great business idea that this website's going to really fit with, then you're getting one of the top Bitcoin-related websites that exist, and you can't find too many of those with that kind of momentum. So in that case, it's worth a lot. If you don't have a great idea to put on this site, then it's not worth that much.
Yeah, I don't imagine somebody with no ideas will be bidding on this.
Some people could conceivably have a lot of money and believe that they've got an idea, that they'll come up with an idea.
SpendBitcoins.com/sale if you want to place your bid. You got 4 days left to do it. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. So we were talking about peace officers and roads, and there's been a lot written on the roads subject. I don't want to rehash a bunch of it here, but Mark, I think there was an important point that you wanted to make because I had said, well, you know, how do we get from here to a situation where the government doesn't take care of the roads? And that's really the big question. I mean, we can all envision—
flying cars.
Well, that's a nice idea, but at least while the federal
government's
around.
There's all kinds of videos of them out there.
Well, no, that's a 60s technology that's been essentially
banned. It's been crushed
by
the federal government. So I was going to say, as long as the federal government's around, that's not an option on the table. So immediately after the New Hampshire secedes, certainly the government will still be taking care of the roads, but that is not an ideal situation. A more ideal situation would be to have competition in roads and, you know, have an open marketplace in providing road services. But
yeah, and not arrest people for trying to build them, which I believe they would do if you tried to build one. They did threaten a lady for trying to take care of a right-of-way in New Hampshire. Yeah.
Really?
So the New Hampshire, the way it is in New Hampshire, the deeds are written that people already possess, basically to the midline of the road. So there's no other—
I've heard this in multiple places.
Yeah, there's no other option. I have a piece of paper. In my case, I believe I actually own the whole section of road because—
You own the part across the street too, right?
Yeah, because but I can't— it's completely useless. I mean, I don't do anything with it. Mm-hmm. So that section of road legally belongs to me. The government has just sort of claimed some level of dominion over it. So— at that point, if for whatever reason government says, all right, we're getting out of the road business, which sounds ludicrous, you know, then that piece of road is already on paper. You know, I've got a deed for it. It's mine. Now, I likely wouldn't want to maintain a piece of road or charge people for the passage across my land.
Some company would come along and offer to buy it from you?
Right. They'd probably offer me a piece of offer me some money and say, hey, look, we're going to take care of this, and you'll have a nice spot to drive out on to.
Yeah.
Also, this is not an issue that needs to be solved anytime soon. You could, as an interim measure, simply let the gas tax take care of roads. And that way, it is a tax.
But the government does a crappy job of this.
Yeah, but at least it's you know, the people who use it are funding it, and there's no real innocent bystanders being forced to pay for it.
It is one of the least objectionable.
It's been done. Taxes. It's known. Everyone knows how it works out. It's not something new and scary. So we could set that aside to be the last thing that ever gets changed, right?
I'm fine with that. But this is what libertarians love to argue about, right?
Well, this is statist FUD: fear, uncertainty, and doubt. So you have a conversation with somebody about the ideas of liberty, and in the case of the caller, he's maybe he's taking on the whole full voluntarist view, where mm-hmm. It's that the state should dissolve, and that we should have lots of competing governments that aren't tied to land masses. This is all very interesting. And then somebody immediately, who hasn't had these conversations very much, immediately will say, what about the roads? You know, the roads are something we all use every day. They're certainly great. Well, we're going to move to more human liberty as time goes by. If we do move to a stateless society, we will either move incrementally or we will move all at once. Moving all at once means the total collapse of the state. That's going to be pretty bad for everybody. We're talking about an eat the dog scenario, right? I mean, it's going to be bad.
Not necessarily. I'm not sure I buy that. However, the kind of scenario where the government goes away, something powerful enough to take that away might be nuclear, right? So it would come with all these side effects that would not be government related, but you related.
Mm. I don't want to be anywhere near a metro center when the state disappears. There are a lot of people who are financially dependent on the government, and those people are going to try to start getting food at some point.
Oh, yeah.
And those people are going to go from cities out towards the country in order to find food, because food doesn't come from cities. It comes from countries, from the country area. And so they're going to go out there in droves looking for food. And
well, that's if the market cannot react fast enough. And I'm not positive that the market is incapable of the market is a lot of people acting on their own initiative. That's all it is.
The market we'll certainly
and
kept people fed
they
in.
They want to make money. They're going to move fast.
In the Soviet Union, wasn't it the black market that helped keep people fed? Give them other options besides moldy bread and water?
Well, Europe went through rationing periods after wars, too. So, I mean, it's pretty clear. And then there were black markets that popped up there, too. So, yes, I think that that's the case. But, were there crimes committed for food in post-communist Russia? I suspect there were. I don't particularly want to be on the receiving end of that. I'm advocating for a smooth transition for more liberty as time goes by.
You don't always get to choose that.
Always get to choose that. That's why you should have a gun. Okay? But for the days that you do get to choose it, you can advocate for it. And in that advocation, I'm going to say that the government's going to get out of roads last. It's probably going to
And that's okay.
Right.
And yeah, sure.
When people advocate for the government, when they advocate for the state, it's cops, courts, causeways, and killers. It's the police, it's roads, it's the judicial system, and it's soldiers. Those are the ones that they believe that the government has to have the monopoly on. We have to have that, because if they don't, then...
Because monopoly works better than... Oh, wait, no, it doesn't.
Yeah, it doesn't. but those are the ones that they have. So, there you go. That's the issue. Those are the areas that the government's going to get out of last. I know it's a Republican-y sounding point, but that's what I believe. If there's an incremental move, those will be the last places.
No problem continuing to have soldiers, cops, roads, all these different trappings. Just
fund them voluntarily.
Acts of aggression, no initiation of force, no taxation.
Unfortunately, federal judge Catherine Forrest doesn't understand that. You remember this name? She's the judge in the Silk Road case.
Yes.
There's breaking, well, somewhat breaking news, I guess, in that that area. Reason Magazine has been subpoenaed. I don't know if you heard about this. Over their readers' comments about the Silk Road
judge.
I
have heard, yeah.
Federal prosecutors have demanded that libertarian news site Reason.com help them identify readers. This is from the Wall Street Journal, who discussed killing a federal judge, including via wood chipper, in the comments section of an article about Silk Road founder Ross Ulbricht. A June 2nd grand jury subpoena obtained by Pope
Wood chipper would probably be a relatively humane way to send somebody out, as long as you wouldn't put them in head first.
Ken White, and a wood chipper seems like an obvious, you know, this isn't serious kind of comment, but
yeah,
you
okay.
never know.
Yeah, seems like it.
Asks Reason to provide.
You just shouldn't make violent threats against people ever. Like, there's, I understand that,
I agree.
That language is getting stolen from us every single day, but the whole I'm going to kill you thing as a joke, yeah, it's just not.
And now it's Reason work. That's the one's going to suffer some of the consequences here. I mean, they don't know who's commenting on their website. They don't have control over that. I mean, you can always moderate stuff, but usually you allow comments without moderation in advance. And so now they're being told, and the article says they're being asked to provide this information, but a subpoena doesn't ask you to
do
things.
Reason, get video of all these interactions.
Asking Reason to provide any and all identifying information for readers who wrote macabre comments in reaction to the life sentence Mr. Ulbricht received from the judge, Catherine Forrest, in Manhattan. It's judges like these that should be taken out back and shot, wrote one commenter. We can talk more about this tomorrow. Check out Ridley over at RidleyReport.com and join us online. FreeTalkLive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN. FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, June 10th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.20 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,191 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $233. Antiwar.com reports the Syrian Observatory for Human Rights has reported that a key Syrian army base in the Daraa province has fallen to the U.S.-backed Free Syrian Army rebel faction, whose southern